Boswell Media Sports.
It is the opening day of baseball here for your Kosciusko Whippets. It wasn't supposed to be the opening day, but it is. You know, things get moved up this time of year. So a Saturday game gets moved to Thursday. But, hey, earlier baseball is always good baseball. Brett Riley with you here from the Itala County Fairgrounds, Whippets Stadium. We got Donald back at the studio. And we're ready for another season of Kosciusko Whippets baseball from Boswell Media Sports. This is the Premier Medical pregame show. It is the Whippets versus the Rockets, and has become a little bit of a rivalry series, obviously with the location, the proximity, and the familiarity between the teams, the coaches. So, yeah, which is what we'll all get into a little bit more of that as we get on to the ball game. But we do appreciate you for tuning in. You can hear us on your radio dial 101.1 Breezy 101 if you're here in the local area. Also, we have the online streams. Those are brought to you by Allen's Furniture, and you can hear us on the Breezy 101 app on the Listen Live tab at breezynews.com. We also have the video feed for you on the Boswell Media YouTube channel. You will find that if you're subscribed to the YouTube channel, you probably got a notification, or if you go to breezynews.com, you'll see the graphic right there when you log in, and we appreciate Allen's Furniture for bringing us those video streams. Now we got the video up for you and ready to go. It is the Kosciusko Whippets. We mentioned first game of the year. These two teams already met in a jamboree last week. They went over to Neshoba, take on the Rockets here. That game ended tied 3-3. So we're going to find out who's the better of the two. They're going to play a return game over in Philadelphia again. I believe that game's going to be on March the 2nd, so we'll have that for you. But it's year number three for Coach Cole McBride and the Kosciusko Whippets. Last year, the Whippets went to the first round of the playoffs, had a great three-game series, ended up losing out to Pontotoc. And so Coach McBride and the Whippets are looking to turn that around. He's assisted by Coach Wesley Dew. And on the other side, it's Coach Jonathan Jones. It's, you know, very familiar to Whippet fans here. He's been the coach over there, I believe, since 2019, 2020, around those times. Was here for about 15, 16 seasons as the head coach of the Kosciusko Whippets. While we have some time here, we will get to tonight's starting lineups. And they are brought to you by Holmes Community College. We'll go with Kosciusko first. That way, in case we get cut off by the start of the ball game, we'll at least have the Whippet starting lineup. Starting for the Whippets, batting first and on the pitcher's mound, it's sophomore Braxton Smith. Another sophomore. He'll bat second, play second. That's Holden McGee. A returning starter for the Whippets, Benny Powell. He'll play center field. He's a junior. Another returning starter, Barrett Kewin. He's catching things up behind home plate, batting fourth. John Wyatt Rusko, he's in left field. He'll bat fifth. Bailey Powers, bat sixth. The junior plays first base. You got Aiden Howard, the sophomore, playing third. You got Reggie Carter starting in right field. He's a senior. And you got Braden Rigby batting ninth and playing shortstop. No designated player for the Whippets. Everybody that's in the lineup is going to be playing in the field and batting. So those starting lineups brought to you by Holmes Community College, as we have the coaches meeting at home plate, a teacher versus student there. Coach McBride played for Coach Jones when Coach Jones was the coach here for those many years. And so these teams, they wanted to play. They wanted to get the game in. That's what they wanted to do, because it's supposed to be not necessarily bad weather, but not ideal weather tomorrow and Saturday. So we'd rather have, it's been a nice day so far here in Kosciusko. And so they wanted to get the game in while we had nice weather rather than the 40-degree temperatures that we would have had on Saturday if this game had been played there. Taking a look at your field conditions and your weather report brought to you by the Itala County Co-op Field. Looks pretty good for early in the season. 58 degrees and no real wind. It's kind of dead. Maybe some a wind gusts up to 5 miles an hour. But those are your field conditions and your weather report brought to you by the nice folks at the Itala County Co-op. So we understand that we're going to have the starting lineups, and I believe starting lineups for the away team, home team. Then we would step aside for the prayer and the national anthem. So we're going to have to just, you know, first game of the year for everyone, umpires, press box staff. So we're just going to have to wait and see what the protocol is. And so I believe we will indeed get the starters for the Neshoba Cetnral Rockets.
Kosciusko High School Whippets. Tonight, your season opener against the Neshoba Cetnral baseball team, the Rockets.
We do have starters for the Neshoba Cetnral Rockets, and we'll call them out to you when we call them out with the PA.
At center field, batting first, number 22, Jordan Davis.
Jordan Davis will play center field.
Number six at shortstop,
a senior, Sanders Griffiths.
Batting third, number 16,
R.B. Harden, the senior East Central signee, is going to be catching and batting third.
Batting fourth, number 13, Will Williams.
Will Williams, he is batting fourth. He's a junior. He'll be on the bump.
DeMarquez West. Number 11.
He's batting fifth. He'll be at first base.
Number 25, Caleb Timms.
J.P. Hancock, the junior, bats sixth, plays second base. Caleb Timms bats seventh, plays left field.
Designated hitter, Ryder White.
Ryder White.
Batting ninth.
He'll bat seventh. He'll be the designated hitter.
Starting at third base,
number 20. Logan Collins will be your right fielder. He's a sophomore and in the playing defense for the Rockets, but not in the batting order will be the freshman, Alandric Hawthorne. So it goes Davis, Griffiths, Harden, Williams, West, Hancock, Timms, White, and Collins with Hawthorne there in the third base position. Revisit the starters for your Kosciusko Whippets.
Number one, your pitcher, Braxton Smith.
Bring him up on the screen right there.
Batting second at second base, number 22.
So you have Holden McGee, the sophomore at second base.
Batting third, your center fielder, number 11, Benny Powell.
Benny Powell, the start at center field. Batting we mentioned four, one of a few returning starters.
Catcher, Barrett Hewitt.
Aaron Kewen catching things up behind home plate.
In left field, number 27, John Wyatt Rusko.
John Wyatt Rusko's in left field.
Batting sixth at first base, number 15, Bailey Powers.
Bailey Powers, the junior.
Batting seventh.
First base, we'll pitch some for the Whippets.
Third base, number 25, Aiden Howard.
Sophomore Aiden Howard will bat seventh, play third base.
Batting eighth. At right field, number 10, Reggie Carter.
Reggie Carter, the senior, the class president. Oh, bat eighth and play right field. And you got a freshman, Braden Rigby, at shortstop. We're going to go ahead and step aside for our prayer and our national anthem. We come back. We'll get you set for the first pitch. This is Kosciusko Whippets Baseball from Boswell Media Sports.
The beauty of spring starts at the Itala County Co-op. From your lawn to your flower beds, the Itala County Co-op will make it stand out against the rest with fountain, outdoor furniture, plants, and yard art. It's t-shirt weather, and the Itala County Co-op has a large selection of Old Row, Southern Point, and Strutton Cotton t-shirts, and new spring apparel from Ariat and Carhartt. For the perfect drinking experience, grab a brewmate before you head out to the baseball or softball field. The Itala County Co-op, Highway 12 East in Kosciusko.
When an electrical shortage in your office causes extensive smoke and water damage, or that musty odor indicates you might have a mold problem, you need a lot more than just help cleaning up. That's why ServPro Northeast Deltalands is the authority when disaster strikes. We offer all the cleanup and construction services to take your home or business to good as new and as soon as possible. So no matter what happens, there's just one call you need to make. Call ServPro Northeast Deltalands at 662-289-7473 to see how we can help you back to like it never even happened. Franchises are independently owned and operated.
Have you been putting off coming to the dentist lately? Hello, I'm Dr. Adam Middleton from Autumn Ridge Dental in Kosciusko. We are treating patients with a mindset we have always held, that proper, regular, preventive care can help keep your mouth healthy and functioning properly. We want all our patients to have a smile they can be proud of. Please call us at 662-289-7076 for an appointment. Come see us, and we will give you something to smile about.
Flu shots are now available at all Premier Medical Group locations for infants 6 months through adults. Come in today and get your flu shot. Just walk in and they will see you shortly. Flu shots are now available ages 6 months and up. Premier Medical Group in Kosciusko, Carthage, and Holmes Community College in Goodman, and Trace Urgent Care.
Premier Medical Group, PMG.
Good health is our priority.
Boswell Media Sports.
Wrapped up the national anthem and just a few moments away from baseball here from the Itala County Fairgrounds. Thanks for tuning in. You can get us on your radio, or I know we probably have a lot of people that have their have us on their smart TVs. That's what we love about being on YouTube, is that you can put it in the smart TV and just sit there in your living room and watch the broadcast. Well, it's going to be Braxton Smith on the mound for the Whippets, the sophomore coming off of surgery. He was injured towards the end of the season last season. Kind of missed the last, I don't know, 2 or 3 weeks. End up having surgery, so he's going to get the go tonight, and as you might expect, you know, coming back from arm surgery, just sort of, you know, trying to get the arm healthier, you know, a little bit here, a little bit there. So we'll see what he can come up with. But he will face off against Jordan Davis, Sanders Griffiths, and R.B. Harden, the top three in the order for the Neshoba Cetnral Rockets. These teams met last year. Third game of the season. It was a February 18th game, so almost a year ago, right here in Kosciusko. That was a 3-2 win for the Kosciusko Whippets. They would go up March the 4th. There was a return trip over to Philadelphia, and Neshoba Cetnral won that game 7-2. So, split with the teams last year, as we mentioned. They are very, very familiar with each other. So, stepping in for the Rockets will be Jordan Davis. Davis is a senior. He signed to play with Mississippi Gulf Coast, one of four players in this Neshoba Cetnral lineup that will play their baseball at the next level, the JUCO level. We'll tell you about them throughout the broadcast. And a couple of these younger guys in the underclassmen are committed to JUCOs. So we'll give you all that information. Going to be a little bit behind 7 o'clock when it comes to first pitch. The lefty steps in, and there's a strike. First pitch was at 7:05. That first pitch is brought to you by Central Electric Power Association. They got a righty-lefty matchup here. Davis swings, sends that one foul back over the batting cage to our left. They got a good uniform matchup tonight. If you're not watching and you're only listening, I'll give you the uniforms look after this pitch from Braxton Smith. It runs up a little bit high for ball one. I kind of elevated on it, but the visitors for Neshoba Cetnral are going with the all reds. They got red tops, red pants. They have blue numerals trimmed in white. Swing, and Davis was able to foul off a piece of that one. They also, the Neshoba Cetnral will put that piping down the side, blue with the white stripe down the middle. And they have Neshoba written across the chest there. After this, we'll tell you what the Whippets are going with tonight. Smith winds and delivers, and that one's rocketed into right field. Carter dives. It's going to get past him. It'll roll all the way to the wall. Davis is on his horse, headed for third. Here comes the relay, and he's going to be in sliding with the triple. Oh, a triple. Carter gave it its best effort, a diving effort in right field, and it got under his glove and rolled past him. So that sends Sanders Griffiths to the plate. Oh, but the Whippets going with the all-white uniforms, what I would call the Stormtrooper look. They have white tops, white pants, white helmet. White hat. See, I'm still thinking about Stormtroopers with the helmet. They have a maroon K, maroon bill, maroon numerals. First pitch is a high swinging strike to Griffiths. They got him to chase that high fastball. But you got Whippets written in maroon across the chest for Kosciusko. Smith working from the stretch now. Took a little something off of that one. Stayed up in the zone for ball one. Sanders Griffiths, he's another one of those Neshoba Cetnral Rockets assigned to play baseball. He'll be going over to East Mississippi. That pitch is in the other side. It gets past Kewin. There's going to be a play at the plate, and sliding under it was Davis, who comes home on the wild pitch. And Neshoba goes up 1-0. Two and one the count. Yeah, Griffith's going to be going over to Scuba to play with a former Whippet, Jacob Nunn. We'll tell you about him later in the broadcast, and we get our alumni update. Pitch is fouled off. We get two balls and two strikes. We are in the top of the first inning. First innings for Whippet Baseball are brought to you by Pickles Drugstore. There's a little chopper back to Smith off the left side of the bag. He'll run underhand toss for the out. So one down. One down in the inning, and we'll bring up the number three batter, which will be the catcher, R.B. Harden. Harden going to East Central Community College. So those guys signed a little bit earlier this year. And isn't it sort of an excuse me swing there from Harden? He's not able to check it up, so he goes around. No balls, one strike to count. 1-0, your score, Neshoba Cetnral, top of the first inning. We got a whistle and time. We got an R.B. Harden chant coming from the dugout over to our right. There's a breaking ball, comes back and finds the inner corner of the plate. A lot of movement on that one.
Let's go, defense!
That one's going to be swung on a foul back over our head towards the softball field. Kosciusko Lady Whippet softball. They're going to be playing this weekend, going down to Lake to play in the tournament. Softball, first year for new head coach Wade Moore. There's a good-looking curveball. Gets him looking. Freezes him in place. Two down now. Good-looking pitch there. Strikeouts for Whippet Baseball, brought to you by Dickerson Petroleum. Smith, after giving up the triple, and we'll come back and get the next two batters. It'll be pitcher versus pitcher matchup here as Will Williams, the righty, digs in. He's a junior. First pitch a little out of the zone for ball one. Williams, a junior, but he is committed to play for East Central. Fastball stayed high again. Makes two balls and no strikes. Oh. chant coming from the dugout. We got a whistle in time. Braxton Smith taking a little while to get a look from his catcher. Now there's a wind and deliver. That one's hit to shortstop. It's a little dribbler. Howard's going to have to barehand it. Throw not in time. It'll hit off the dugout, roll back into the field, but that one's just a little infield single. Like I said, a little dribbler. Good job on the effort by Howard to barehand it and try to make at least a play, but
that's a good fit.
He not able to get the out, so we got a two-out single, runner on first base. And we had a courtesy runner for the pitcher. Didn't get to see who that runner was. We're trying to get you that number, but anyway, stepping into the plate, it's going to be the senior, DeMarquez West. Marquez West looks at strike one on a fastball right down the middle. Good job there by Smith coming right after him. DeMarquez West, he's going to be playing his college baseball at Decatur. Runner goes, hit and run on, and DeMarquez West fouls it off. Graham Fulton going to be your pinch runner for the pitcher. Appreciate the guys here in the press box getting us that number over towards first base. But 0-2, Braxton Smith trying to get out of the first inning with minimal damage. Neshoba Cetnral plated one already. Quick throw down to first, and runner Norton is back in time. Pitch a little bit out of the zone for ball one outside. Good pop-up throw there by Kewen. So one ball and two strikes the count. Smith working from the stretch. Big lead over at first for Norton. And there's the throw. They get him in a rundown. Powers going to try to get to McGee. McGee going to throw back to Smith. Smith going to get him down and tag him out on the throwdown. So the Whippets get out of the inning with minimal damage. There was one run on two hits, no errors, and nobody left on base. We'll head to the bottom of the first inning. The Neshoba Cetnral Rockets lead it 1-0.
Here's something I bet you don't know. You could go to college for free. Do you have a 20 on your ACT?
Yes. Whoa. Wait. So my tuition is free? Where?
Home CC. Yes, every word you just heard is absolutely true. Goodman, Kosciusko, Grenada, Ridgeland, Yazoo City, online. Does not matter.
Why in the world would Holmes Community College offer free tuition with a 20 on the ACT?
Simple. At Holmes, we don't want you drowning in college debt the rest of your life.
You know, I have heard students with associate degrees from Holmes often make more money than four-year students with bachelor and master degrees.
True. Plus, at Holmes, you get three-day weekends. So there's that.
Sweet.
So now you know. Your tuition is free with a 20 on your ACT at Holmes CC.
No place like Holmes.
Holmes Community College.
Boswell Media Sports.
It's the bottom of the first inning here from the Italian County Fairgrounds. 1-0, Neshoba Cetnral leads Kosciusko. They got a leadoff triple by Jordan Davis. Ended up coming around and scoring a wild pitch. But after that, Braxton Smith settled down. He got a strikeout, ground out, did give up a single, but then the Whippets were able to get the runner in a rundown and get out of the inning. So for the Whippets, it'll be Braxton Smith, Holden McGee, and Benny Powell due up here in the first inning. They'll be facing off against the pitcher, Will Williams. Obviously, first game of the year, we don't have any pitching stats, no no batting averages, really not much of anything to give you. So we'll do what we can. The sophomore Braxton Smith going to lead things off. You got Williams on the mound, a big right-hander. And Smith Digging in. Williams working from the windup. First pitch low and inside for ball one. Set the defense for you after this pitch. Pitch caught just a little bit of the corner. Good framing job there by the catcher, Harden. So you got Williams on the mound, Harden behind the plate. At the corners, West at first, Hawthorne at third. Up the middle, Griffiths plays shortstop. Hancock is at second as Smith swings and fouls one off towards the softball field down the right field line. Going from left to right in the outfield, Caleb Timms, Jordan Davis, and Logan Collins. Did we run out of baseballs? Or just waiting to get a... No. Yeah, waiting to get a pitch. Williams was looking at the dugout like we might have been waiting for a ball to come in. But, no, just getting a pitch from his pitching coach. That's a strike outside, a little bit on the outside corner, but Smith goes down swinging, out number one, and it is Holden McGee to step in for Kosciusko.
Number 22, Holden McGee.
Holden McGee, a sophomore, he's a second baseman. One to nothing. Bottom of the first inning. First inning's presented by Pickles Drug Store. First pitch swinging, hits it up high up in the air. Harden's going to give chase, and it's going to come back in, and he can't make the catch. It kind of drifted on him, looked like he had set up under it. Then drifted back towards the batter's circle, not able to complete the play. But, yeah, first pitch swinging aggressive at the plate there for Holden McGee. And that one was a danger to all low-flying aircraft. That one was up there for a while. What? So, 0-1 to count to Holden McGee. Sort of a breaking ball there, broke late. McGee able to get enough of a bat on it, just foul it off, but not able to do anything with it. It's an 0-2 count. So Williams will look to his wrist to get a play. Or get the pitch, I should say. 0-2 pitch. It's hit to second base. Hancock runs to his left and throws to first for the out. Hard hit ball, but unfortunately right to the defender. It'll be two down in the inning. And you get Benny Powell stepping in.
Benny Powell,
the junior center fielder. One of the returning starters for the Whippets, his older brother, playing baseball at Wamba Community College. And I said, we'll talk more about those Whippet alums in that section of the broadcast. That pitch is an off speed. It comes inside corner, rolls away from the catcher, Harden. Oh, 0-1 the count. Powell taking his time. Williams toes the rubber. There's a pitch that's a little bit low and outside. Didn't miss by too much. Oh. Count leaving up at a ball and a strike to junior center fielder Powell. There's another little breaking ball that stays inside, didn't break the way Williams wanted it to. Two outs, bottom of the first inning. Kosciusko trailing Neshoba Cetnral 1-0. Opening night of baseball here across the state of Mississippi. Some people might have played earlier in the year, or earlier in the week, as Powell fouls that one down the first base line. Some games played earlier this week. Some games scheduled for Tuesday rained out. So a lot of teams getting their first action of the 2024 season tonight. Kosciusko's game tomorrow night has been moved up. They're still scheduled to take on East Webster. but it's going to be there on a flip-flop, the JV and the varsity game. 2-2 pitch to Powell. An outside count runs full. Yeah, tomorrow they'll play the varsity game at 4 o'clock here against East Webster, and weather permitting, they'll do the JV after that. That was announced a little bit earlier today. Got some rain moving into the area before the temperatures plummet on Saturday. That's why this game was moved to today. Payoff pitch. Deep hit to left field. It's left fielder going back. It's gone! Benny Powell with a solo shot. And just like that, the Whippets have tied the ball game. Benny Powell, what a way to start your junior campaign. Just turned on a pitch off to the left side. He went down over left field, right behind the football press box, if you're familiar with the setup here at the ballpark. So, Whippets tied on one swing, and that is Benny Powell.
Number seven, Barrett Kewen. It
brings up Barrett Kewen, the junior catcher. And he takes one right between the shoulder blades. That one stings. So imagine we're going to get a runner for Kewen.
Now batting number 27.
So let's see. John Wyatt Rusko is going to come in to bat. And Christian Thrash will come out to run for Baird Kewen. So that's what we have here as we get a visit to the mound from Coach Jonathan Jones, maybe just trying to calm down his pitcher, gives up a home run, and then the very next pitch hits a batter. Coach Jones doesn't want things to get away from his team, but John Wyatt Rusko, the lefty, will step in, the first lefty in the lineup for Kosciusko. He's a junior left fielder. So Christian Thrash over at first base. Oh. Now Williams having to work from the stretch for the first time. Fastball high outside for ball one. So 1-0 the count. You got DeMarquez West over at first base holding on Christian Thrash. I'll tell you, Thrash is a sophomore. Pretty big lead for Thrash over at first. Williams will give him a long look. Long look at the plate. Rusko looks at a fastball right down the middle for strike one. Maybe catches a little bit off the left side of the plate. So Rusko will look at his arm and get the play call. Oh. Williams, once again, will look to his arm to get the pitch. Pickles Drugstore brings you first innings for Whippets baseball. Throw back over, Thrash under the tag. It's a close play over at first. Williams got a really good move over to first, and Coach Wesley Duell woke up, give some coaching tips to the sophomore Thrash. Oh, Thrash takes off. Throw down to second is going to get past and roll into center field, and Thrash is going to have to stay there. So Thrash takes second base on the stolen base, and that pitch was called a ball. Two balls, one strike to count. Whippets got a runner in scoring position now with Christian Thrash at second base. Got Bailey Powers on deck. If Rusko is able to reach base, extend the inning. Another big lead out at second on the base paths for Thrash. High outside, ball three.
Your pitch here, Rusko.
3-1. Runner on second, first base open. I'm not sure Williams will give Rusko much to look at right here. But we'll see what he comes up with. Another big lead, but nobody holding a runner on out at second. That was it, right back up the middle over the bag at second. They're going to send Thrash home. Throw is cut off. Big, big hit by John Wyatt. Rusko gives the Whippets a lead, 2-1. So just right over the bag, right back up the middle. The old RBI single for Rusko, and Thrash comes around to score. Whippets take the lead, 2-1. Bailey Powers will step into the plate, the right-hander, the junior first baseman. Bailey Powers also do some pitching for the Whippets. Imagine we'll see him maybe tomorrow, after tomorrow, and then maybe the Tuesday against Madison Central. Rusko's going to take off, hit and run, going to get past the third baseman. They're going to hold the runner at second. Good job of hitting there by Powers. So we've got runners on first and second now. Two outs. That brings up Aiden Howard to the plate. Howard is sophomore, playing third base. Well, we had a stoppage there, but I believe the three-man umpiring crew was kind of trying to see where everybody was supposed to go. Rusko had a big lead out at second base, and Williams just kind of turned around and faked the throw. We're going to have another meeting between the officials. But here, we'll reset it for you. It is Kosciusko with a two-run first inning. They lead it 2-1, bottom of the first. Runners on first and second with Aiden Howard, the lefty, stepping in. Will Williams still on the plate and – or on the mound, I should say. And let's say the umpires kind of had a little bit of a meeting out in the midfield area. So, not sure what the discussion was about there between the officials, but they got it sorted out. Howard looks at a fastball off the plate for ball one. Oh, Aiden Howard, big kid, sophomore, lefty. Williams with a long look back at second, and Rusko. Another pitch runs off the plate for ball two. Whippets doing some damage with two outs as R.B. Harden will walk out and talk to his pitcher, Will Williams. So you got a senior right here walking out to talk to the junior Williams. I feel like Harden's been playing baseball for Neshoba for, I don't know, a long time. Maybe he's got an older brother that I'm thinking of. But I feel like Harden's been there for a long time. Good ball player. We mentioned going over to play his college ball at East Central Community College. So Harden takes his place back behind the plate. And Williams winds to deliver. Runs right down the middle for strike one. I think Williams needed that one. He had been having some trouble locating. So we'll look back at the shortstop Griffiths, kind of doing some defensive calls out there from his shortstop. Let everyone know where the plays are. It's kind of some cat and mouse going on back there. There's a little bit of a change up there, and Howard able to foul it off, but that's all he can do. Well, count evens up at 2-2. Still in the first inning. Whippets went down the first two batters at the plate, strikeout, ground out. And they've been able to get some guys on. As Williams looks back to Griffiths to get the defensive calls. Everybody playing straight up. No real shifts on or anything. Another long look back at the bag at second. And now they're going to throw, and Wesco back in under the tag. But there was no tag, really, as Griffiths went to put the tag down, and the ball had rolled away out of his glove. Tried to put the tag down before he had the ball. And we'll do it all over again. The lefty Howard steps in. Two pitch. Swinging strike three. That does it. But the Whippets, they take the lead. They get two runs on two hits, one error, and two left on base. Through one complete inning, Kosciusko leads it 2-1.
When an electrical shortage in your office causes extensive smoke and water damage, or that musty odor indicates you might have a mold problem, you need a lot more than just help cleaning up. That's why ServPro Northeast Deltalands is the authority when disaster strikes. We offer all the cleanup and construction services to take your home or business to good as new and as soon as possible. So no matter what happens, there's just one call you need to make. Call ServPro Northeast Deltalands at 662-289-7473 to see how we can help you back to like it never even happened. Franchises are independently owned and operated.
When it comes to insurance, one size does not fit all. At Alpha, the Chris Coleman Agency in Kosciusko, knowing the customer and their individual needs is what we pride ourselves on. We know how important it is for everyone to have the peace of mind that your insurance coverages are tailored for you. Our team recognizes your life and your unique needs. That is why we provide you with numerous insurance options, an easy claim process, and personal attention that is second to none, all at one location without breaking the bank. Call us today at 662-289-1024 or visit us at 235 North Madison Street off the square in Kosciusko. At Alpha, the Chris Coleman Agency, we guarantee the right fit for you and all of your insurance needs.
Boswell Media Sports.
We go to the top of the second inning. Kosciusko with a lead 2-1 over their rivals from just across the county line, Neshoba Cetnral, the Rockets. It's 2-1, as it will be due up for the Rockets. It'll be 4, 5, and 6, as DeMarquez West was at the plate last time Will Williams got thrown out in a rundown. So DeMarquez West will step in. It'll be West, J.P. Hancock, Caleb Timms, and it's Braxton Smith on the mound for the Whippets. Second innings for Whippet Baseball, brought to you by Kangaroo Crossing. Curveball stays in a little on the first pitch from Smith. Yeah, in the bottom half of the first inning, it was a Benny Powell home run. It was a two-out home solo home run that tied the game. This here comes a second curveball is off the plate for ball two. And then it was a walk or a hit by pitch for Baird Kewen, as an excuse me swing is fouled off to the right side of the field. Kewen ended up coming around to score on a John Wyatt Rusko single as Christian Thrash came into the pinch run. And he got the second on a stolen base, and then Rusko brought him home. So the Whippets got there. Well, that one's hit to the gap at shortstop past a diving Rigby. It'll be a leadoff single for DeMarquez West. That was a hard, hard hit ball. Rigby had to run off to his left to try to dive and stop it. So that'll bring up Hancock, the junior second baseman. Hancock not signed anywhere yet, as he is just a junior, but I talked to Coach Jones earlier today. He said Hancock has committed to play for Meridian Community College. He shows bunt, snap throw down to first, and DeMarquez West back in plenty of time. No surprise there if you're familiar with Coach Jones' philosophy. A little small ball being played. You're going to have the third baseman, Howard, playing a little bit in on the grass. So you got DeMarquez West with not too big of a lead at first. But yeah, Hancock, the junior. Didn't show bunt that time. Fastball, once again, stays out of the zone for ball two. 2-0 the count. So we got a long time. Time was granted, but Hancock never stepped into the batter's box. Smith working from the stretch. Delivers ball hitting the right field, shallow right field. Reggie Carter coming on will make the catch for the first out. Reggie Carter playing right field. Whippets do have a couple of starters that are out as they're still playing basketball. You got Andrew Mansell and Ryan Tillman, both starters for the Whippet basketball team. And Mansell probably, when he gets back into shape, baseball shape, will get in the outfield somewhere. I believe last year he played some right field. Tillman right up the middle, either second base or shortstop when they get them back. As the first pitch to Caleb Timms is low and outside for ball one. But yeah, Tillman and Mansell are going to be going with the Whippet basketball team tomorrow night to New Albany. Second round of the playoffs. They defeated Shannon earlier this week. West going to take off. It's a swing. There's a throw, and they're going to get him in a rundown. McGee going to try to tag him, and he does. Caught him stealing. Great job by Barrett Kuehn and Holden McGee. And it was a hit and run. And Timms did his best to try to hit the high fastball, but couldn't come up with it. So it'll be two outs now, and Caleb Timms still at the plate. 1-1 pitch. It's a little slow roller to Holden McGee at second. He'll field it. A couple of hops and throws to first for the out, and that retires the side. No runs, one hit, no errors, and nobody left on base. We'll go to the bottom of the second inning. Kosciusko in the lead, 2-1.
Hey, I'm James Matters with Farm Bureau Insurance. For the past 6 years, I've been blessed to serve our community as a local insurance agent. When most people think of insurance, they think of their home and auto, which is the natural thing to do. This year, I'm shifting my focus to what's important, family. Protecting your family with life insurance is the most important insurance decision you will ever make. I'd like the opportunity to sit down with you and your family to discuss your life insurance. Together, we can build a plan that fits your needs and your budget. After all, life insurance is more than a policy. It's a promise to take care of the ones you love, no matter what. Give me a call, 289-4862.
Your pharmacist is more than someone who fills your prescriptions. Your pharmacist helps you understand what medications you're taking. Your pharmacist makes sure your insurance is filed correctly. And your pharmacist answers any other questions you may have regarding your medications.
Hi, I'm Rob Pickle, registered pharmacist and owner of Pickle's Drugstore. It is my goal to give you the personal attention you need to improve your health and well-being. My staff and I are here to serve you.
Pickle's Drugstore, your hometown pharmacy, on the east side of the square in Kosciusko.
Boswell Media Sports.
The bottom of the second inning, Kosciusko with the lead 2-1 over Neshoba Cetnral. The Rockets have come to town on the opening day of baseball here from the Italian County Fairgrounds. Brett Riley with you and Donald Bain back at the studio on Golf Course Road. Going to be with you all season long right here on Breezy 101 doing Kosciusko Whippets baseball. The Whippets will send Reggie Carter, Braden Rigby, and Braxton Smith to the plate. That'll be the 8, 9, and 1 hitters coming up. You know, we mentioned that the basketball players that we are missing, Ryan Tillman and Andrew Mansell. You got Reggie Carter, who's a Kosciusko Whippet football player. He just signed last week. He's going to be playing his football down at Mississippi College. Go Choctaws is where Reggie's going. And Reggie also the senior class president. So he's been some playing time here. He'll step in. First pitch swinging over the top of it for strike one. And Whippets had six players sign football scholarships last week on National Signing Day. That's a fastball. It caught the inside corner of the plate for ball or strike two. So Williams quickly ahead in the count to the senior Reggie Carter. Williams gets Carter to swing and miss, so that'll be the third strikeout of the game for Will Williams. It'll bring up the number nine hitter. That's freshman Braden Rigby. Braden Rigby was eighth grader last year, but they brought him up to do some pitching, maybe some running. I remember last year he did a lot of pinch running, a lot of courtesy running last year, did Rigby as an eighth grader. So the freshman shortstop. First pitch is called a strike. Thought it might have been a little bit high and inside, but Williams is really bringing it here. Every pitch in this inning has been in the strike zone. Rigby, a little blooper in the center field, but no. Jordan Davis had him played just right. Thought it was going to get down in front, but it did not. That's two quick outs for the Rockets. However, that's how the last inning started. Two outs, and then the Whippets went on a run with a home run, hit by pitch, a single, a stolen base, and a single to take the 2-1 lead as Braxton Smith will step back in for the Whippets, the leadoff batter. He struck out his only other at-bat. Shows bunt. And the pitch is a little low and outside for ball one. Bottom of the second inning, Whippets with a one-run lead, 2-1. It's Will Williams still working from the windup, nobody else on base. Left field, that one is going to get past the left fielder. Into the gap, Caleb Timms gets it at the wall, and Braxton Smith will cruise into second base with a stand-up double. Yeah, they had Timms was playing not a little far from the line, a lot of room in that left corner, and Smith was able to just find it. And are they going to bring a runner in for Smith, or is Smith going to run for himself? You think? Yeah, yeah. Now they're going to bring in a runner. We weren't quite sure. Oh, are they bringing in? Are they bringing in a runner, or is he just taking off all of his? He's taking off all of his gear, so Smith's going to stay in to run for himself. So he will stay at second base, and it will be Holden McGee stepping in. So Whippets with a runner in scoring position, second straight inning where the Whippets have gotten a two-out hit. Holden McGee, 0-for-1, he grounded out to second. His first at bat was a good hit. He just hit it right to the second baseman Hancock. Smith with a huge lead out at second. He's going to go. Going to get him in a rundown, and he's going to try to slide past the tag. He will not. So, two-out hit goes for naught, but the Whippets still in the lead after two complete innings. We'll head to the third with the Whippets ahead 2-1.
Hello, I'm State Farm Agent Angel Albin McDonald on Highway 12 in Kosciusko. Today's small business owners know just how much hard work is involved in starting and growing a business, but the challenges involved are not foreign to you. You're all in. Still, it doesn't hurt to have some good neighborly help. Like yourself, as a State Farm agent, I'm a small business owner as well. This enables me to help you choose the right insurance coverage to fit your small business needs. So why not insure your small business with the fellow small business owner who also happens to be a good neighbor? Contact me, State Farm Agent Angel Alvin McDonald, on Highway 12 at 662-289-3161.
Have you been putting off coming to the dentist lately? Hello, I'm Dr. Adam Middleton from Autumn Ridge Dental in Kosciusko. We are treating patients with a mindset we have always held, that proper, regular, preventive care can help keep your mouth healthy and functioning properly. We want all our patients to have a smile they can be proud of. Please call us at 662-289-7076 for an appointment. Come see us, and we will give you something to smile about.
Boswell Media Sports.
We'll head to the top of the third inning. Kosciusko with a 2-1 lead over Neshoba Cetnral. Third innings for Whippet Baseball, presented by Renaissance Insurance. I'll tell you about Kosciusko Whippet Tennis. Tennis team was scheduled to play today. It got canceled. They're going to go on the road tomorrow to take on Pontotoc. So they'll go up to North Mississippi. Have a couple of the teams playing in North Mississippi. So that's, what, four teams tomorrow that'll be playing? You'll have baseball playing here against East Webster. The softball team's going to take on Clinton down at the Lake Tournament. You will have the basketball team taking on New Albany tomorrow. So that game was supposed to be on Saturday because the girls' playoffs are tomorrow. Boys are on Saturday. However, New Albany, their soccer team, the boys' soccer team playing for the state championship on Saturday. They didn't want to split the fan base. So the boys are going to play tomorrow night. They'll go on the road, 6 o'clock tip-off in New Albany. Andrew Mansell and Ryan Tillman, we mentioned a couple of the baseball players. They are here. I saw them walking around. They came in the press box a little bit earlier. So they're here cheering on their team, but they are still contributing to the Whippet basketball team. As we will have 8-9-1 due up for the Neshoba Cetnral Rockets as Braxton Smith's first pitch stays up high out of the zone. It's Ryder White, a junior designated hitter. And he is committed to play for East Cetnral. Fastball right down the middle for a ball. I thought that one looked good, but stayed up a little bit apparently. So 2-0 the count to White. He swings at that one, fouls it off. But yeah, White is, we mentioned, committed to East Cetnral. A lot of these guys in the Neshoba area, the Neshoba, Philadelphia area. East Cetnral, Meridian, East Mississippi, kind of where they end up playing college ball. Ball hit in the center field. Powell going to have to drift back. Makes the catch for out number one. Off the bat, it kind of carried a little bit. There's not a lot of wind, but Powell came in and able to make the catch. Or out number one. Logan Collins steps to the plate, the number 9 hitter, sophomore right fielder for the Rockets. As we said, you know, first game of the year, don't have anything in the way of stats or anything at all. First pitch to Collins is a strike. You know, some of these guys played in Jamboree games, but those stats don't get put in the official stat book. So unless you were there at the game taking the stats, you, I don't know. Smith able to get Collins to chase one high and out of the zone, strike two. And so Smith heading the count right here. Smith winds and delivers, swinging, strike three. Second strikeout of the ball game for Braxton Smith, two down. Whippet strikeouts presented by Dickerson Petroleum. We'll go back to the top of the order. It's Jordan Davis who's got the only run so far for the Rockets. Hit one into right field, and Reggie Carter attempted to make a diving catch and almost trapped the ball under his glove, and it rolled past him. And so he got able to – Davis was able to leg out to third base and ended up scoring on a wild pitch after that. But he'll step in, the lefty. So Smith, curveball stays way out of the zone, didn't break like Smith wanted. Yeah, he got him to swing at that one. I believe he caught a little piece of it. Sounded like a little foul tip there. That makes it one ball and one strike. One pitch. Just a little outside. A little off the plate. Didn't miss by much. 2-1, that one comes back and finds it right down the middle for strike two to even the count. So 2-2 count Smith trying to put them down in order for the Whippets. That's swinging, foul ball all over the dugout.
Don't forget, if you get a foul ball, return it to one of our Diamond Girls and you will get a prize.
Third innings for Whippet Baseball, presented by Renaissance Insurance. Another 2-2 pitch coming. That was a good-looking off-speed pitch, but Davis able to stay alive and foul it over towards the Whippet dugout. It was Andrew Mansell, the basketball player we were talking about, comes out of the dugout and gets it for the Whippets. Another 2-2. Another foul ball. The Whippets will give chase, but that's going to get out down beyond the dugout. Whippets swapped locker rooms in the offseason. Used to have the locker room right here below us in the press box. They took over the old football locker room down the left field line. Hadn't been able to get in there yet and see what they have. There's another ball hit on the left field. It'll get over the head of Rusko. That time it stays in play. Davis digging it out for second base, and he's got in there with a stand-up double. That was just a good at-bat by Davis right there, fouling off a few pitches and ended up on second base. So it's a two-out base runner, and it's the leadoff man standing out at second in scoring position. And that will bring a visit to the mound by Coach Wesley Dew. So Coach Dew will come in, and he will bring his infield in. And those pitching timeouts presented by Central Tire Service. We'll take a 30-second break.
What moves you down the road and through the woods? Central Tire Service and Central Trailer Sales with utility trailers in all sizes and truck beds. Central Tire Sales can customize to your specifications. Central Tire Service puts your life in motion with tires engineered to last for your ATV and vehicle. A full-service mechanic and tire shop. Central Tire Service and Central Trailer Sales across from Prairie Farms and Kosciusko.
Boswell Media Sports.
Out of the pitching timeout, Coach Wesley Dew brought in his entire infield, maybe just going over some procedure right here. Got a fast runner out at second base, two outs in the inning. The tying run in the form of Jordan Davis, and you have Sanders Griffiths stepping in at the plate. Look back at second as Smith working from the stretch. Sort of a half swing by Griffiths, but comes up empty-handed. Griffiths grounded out. It's on the other at-bat. He get one back to the pitcher, Braxton Smith, a little slow roller, and Smith was able to throw him out. It was back in the first inning. It's a curveball that stays a little low. Count runs even at one ball and one strike. Davis playing a little cat and mouse out at second base. Griffiths fouls that one off. Makes it one ball and two strikes. The count. To Sanders Griffiths. That one's pitched way outside. Snow cone catch to keep it in front of him by Barrett Kewen. Good job there by the junior. Otherwise, Davis would have been able to trot to third base with his speed. Long look back at second for Smith. Another look back. Throws. Little bit high in the zone for ball three. Did not miss by much. That's one that Smith is hoping that Griffiths just can't lay off of. But the senior there showing you some patience at the plate as the count runs full. Some rhythmic applause from the Neshoba Central dugout. Payoff pitch. That one stays high and it hit. Yeah, it's a curveball. that ends up hitting Griffiths. It doesn't matter either way. Is it would have been ball four. I think Smith thought that maybe the Griffiths leaned into it a little bit, but anyway, Griffiths will end up at first base. Cueing will walk the ball back to the pitcher as Coach McBride comes down to have a chat with the umpire, maybe asking the same thing if he thought that he leaned into it. But as it is, you got runners on first and second, two outs in the inning, and you have the number three hitter, R.B. Harden, stepping in.
Batting number 16, R.B. Harden.
Harden, 0-for-1. He was a strikeout victim. Went down looking on three pitches back in the first. Throw back to second. Holden McGee covering the bag. Davis able to slide in under. Pretty good throw there. Good pickoff move back to second. Now you got Holden McGee kind of calling out some defensive plays from the second base position. Smith will throw to the plate. Curveball outside corner called strike one. A lot of movement there from Smith. Smith kind of running through some signals. He and Cueing trying to get on the same page. Look back at second. Ball pops out of the glove. Runner going to try to go to third. Howard's there. And they're going to say he's safe. Had him there, but I think the ball might have popped out of the glove. That's kind of over in the side of the field where I don't have a great vantage point. I got to lean my head out the window to kind of see. But Cueing jumped up through to third, and I thought it was there. But like I said, maybe I think maybe the ball came loose on the play. But anyway, runners on first and second. First and third, as it's Harbin with a 1-1 count. Cueing had just stepped out from behind home plate to give some signals. Now watch out for that gotcha play right here between first and third. Pitch is outside for ball two.
Make a play, D.
Two balls, one strike, the count to Harden. Will Williams, the pitcher, on deck if Harden's able to extend the inning. Now we got a whistle. No, she's not a whistle, but a stoppage and play for the umpires. I'm still in basketball mode thinking about whistles. Well, now everybody's where they're supposed to be. As Smith delivers. A little bit of an off speed there. Count goes to 3-1. Over in the Whippets trying to maintain their lead. It's a one-run lead, 2-1. They're in the top of the third inning. Harbin looking down to Coach Jonathan Jones to get the play. The runners on the corners. Long set by Smith. And he threw it outside for ball four. And that will load the bases with the cleanup hitter coming to the plate, Will Williams. Well, similar situations the Rockets have come to with the Whippets put together in the bottom of the first inning. Bottom of the first inning. Whippets got two outs very quickly. Then it was Benny Powell with a home run and a two-out rally to give the Whippets their 2-1 lead. The Whippets are hoping to get out of this jam. High outside is the first pitch to Williams. Williams as a single. He singled back in the first inning. However, the run for him, which was Graham Fulton, was thrown out trying to steal second base after that. That ended the first inning. But Smith working back for the windup with the bases loaded, able to come back and find the outside corner for strike one.
Big pitch there by Smith. Needed that. Didn't want to walk didn't want to throw another ball after walking the previous two batters. So you got the infield playing back. Winds. That one comes on the inside for ball two. Setting the defense for you. You got Smith on the mound, queuing behind the plate at the corners. Bailey Powers at first, Aiden Howard at third. Up the middle, Rigby, the freshman at shortstop, holding McGee at second base. Left to right in the outfield, it's Rusko, Powell, and Carter. A little half swing there that Williams went around on to even the count at two balls and two strikes. So you got a 2-2 count. As Williams steps back to get a look from Coach Jones. Whippets needing an out here. Nowhere to put him. I'm trying to get out of a jam and keep that one-run lead. Here's the pitch. That pitch is going to be fouled off for count will remain at two balls and two strikes. Oh. Count remains two balls, two strikes. On top of the third inning. Smith trying to go through some signals between him and Kewin, and Williams asks for time. It's Smith and Kewin trying to get on the same wavelength there. Well, now Williams back in at the plate. 2-2. High fly ball, shallow right field. Reggie Carter coming in, and he will make the catch. Calls off the center fielder Powell, and no damage done. After two and a half complete, there were no runs, one hit, no errors, and three left on base. We'll take a break. We'll go to the bottom of the third inning with the Whippets leading it 2-1.
Physical therapist Haley Kewin at Reliant Physical Therapy. Our staff provides attentive, focused, and compassionate care for every patient to restore you back to your functional level.
Hi, this is Tina McNeil, physical therapist. At Reliant, we offer outpatient physical therapy and post-op care for all ages and circumstances. When you need physical therapy, request Reliant Physical Therapy.
Physical therapists Adam Bell, Haley Kewin, and Tina McNeil, along with assistants Veronica Wolforth and Rebecca Shields Hayden, transforming lives spiritually and physically. Reliant Physical Therapy in Meigs Plaza on Veterans Memorial Drive, Kosciusko.
Boswell Media Sports.
It's the bottom of the third inning. Kosciusko with the lead, 2-1 over Neshoba Cetnral. Due up for the Whippets in this inning will be the heart of the order. 2, 3, and 4. Holden McGee, Benny Powell, and Barrett Kewin. So those three will come to the plate. Let's see, McGee, 0-for-1. He grounded out back in the first inning. He was at the plate in the bottom of the second inning when Braxton Smith was caught trying to steal. So, Whippets trying to extend their lead, 2-1. Third innings for Whippet baseball presented by Renaissance Insurance. So, give you that look at some Whippet alums playing baseball. Jacob Nunn playing at East Mississippi. He started their season earlier this month in one appearance. Jacob has 2 2/3 innings pitched and 2 strikeouts. Kalen Powell playing baseball at Itawamba Community College. He's played in 2 games, has scored 1 run. Follow those guys in their career. You got Ethan Wood playing down at Holmes Community College with Will Carter. Ethan had a home run, his very first at bat of the season. Also got Connor Wallace. The Wallace boys playing down at Holmes. A lot of alumni as McGee shows bunt. And fouls it off. Trying to get a little bunt single. McGee, sophomore, playing second. Last season he had Ryan Tillman playing second. When he comes back from basketball, he's going to be playing one of those infield spots. Not sure if it'll be second or shortstop. Kind of a utility guy. Fastball high for ball one to McGee. So 1-1 pitch. Swinging strike two. I think McGee might have got a little piece of that one. Anyway. Makes it one ball and two strikes. And rolls it to shortstop. It is a good play by Griffiths, who fires it over to first base for the out. Oh, that'll bring up Benny Powell to the plate. Powell, he had the two-out home run back in the first inning. Oh, it was a 3-2 pitch, full count, and just turned on one, sent it to left field. Hey, Whippets would love to do that again right here. Oh, Powell digging in to work against Williams. Give credit to Williams. He comes right after him with a fastball right down the middle of the plate for strike one. Sometimes you give up a home run like that, and you might think you want to dance around him, but not Williams. That pitch is a called strike two. Thought it might have been a little bit low, but Williams not wasting any time coming after the junior Powell. Baird Kewen on deck for the Whippets. Williams to deliver. Outside for ball one. It was a fastball. Tried to get him. Williams trying to get Powell to chase that one. Got some action over in the Whippet bullpen. The Central Tire pitching update may be coming here shortly. 1-2 pitch. It's a little chopper to third. Hawthorne's going to grab it, throw to first, and a good stretch by West to get the out. Well, you got to go quickly to get Powell, who moves down the line pretty well. Some good defense there by the Rockets. Two down in the inning. And Baird Kewen stepping to the plate. Kewen took one between the shoulder blades. His last, his only other appearance. I mean, he didn't have any time. It was the first pitch right between the shoulder blades, and then Christian Thrash comes in to run for him, ends up coming around to score. And Kewen's first pitch swings, comes up empty. In fact, Baird Kewen wearing number seven for his cousin Seth Smith. He played baseball at Ole Miss. Played the pros for the Colorado Rockies, a couple of other programs. Some relation to Kewen, so that's why he wears number seven. And number seven looks at a ball on the inside, even the count at 1-1. Got him to chase that one. Took a little bit off of it, kept it outside. Makes it one ball and two strikes, Kewen behind in the count. Whippets in the lead, 2-1, bottom of the third inning. All runs scored tonight by both clubs were in that first inning. 1-2 pitch inside and in the dirt. Even the count. Two balls and two strikes. A good crowd here for a Thursday night game. Good crowd has made the short drive over from Philadelphia as Kewen calls for time. So he'll step out, now he steps back in. Pitch hits in front of the plate and scoots off wildly over to the right side, and Baird Kewen has worked the count back full. Trying to extend the inning for Kosciusko. If he does, it's John Wyatt Rusko come to the plate. Got some shifting going on up the middle. Hancock kind of moves over towards the bag at second, deep in the hole at second. He had been playing more closer to first as Williams doesn't like the ball. He's going to get a new one from the umpire. Lum didn't feel right about that one. So, Kewin trying to extend the inning for the Whippets. There's Williams. High curve ball stays out of the zone. And Baird Kewin draws a two-out walk. Whippets have a base runner. And I imagine looks like Christian Thrash going to come in and run. Yep. Thrash will come in. He stole a base his last time coming in to run. Ended up getting to second base, and then he came around to score on a John Wyatt Rusko line drive out to left center field. Well, Whippets may be hoping history repeats itself here. Thrash with a big lead over at first. The lefty, now they're going to throw over. He slides in under the tag, but Rusko, I mentioned the lefty. You got Bailey Powers on deck, then Aiden Howard would come to the plate. Howard was who was warming up over when we mentioned some action in the bullpen. Rusko swings at the first pitch, well over the top of that one. Oh. Now Thrash will inch a little bit further from the bag this time. Now there's a throw over and under the tag of DeMarcus West. Williams, he's got a very quick throw over to first. He's got a And Coach Wesley Duke going to walk up and say, do some coaching to Thrash. As Williams reads his card on his left arm, his left wrist to get a play, get a pitch that he wants. And now Rusko looks at strike two. Fastball just coming right down Main Street. Count goes to no balls and two strikes. Teams trying to do a lot of damage with two outs tonight. Both teams have tried to come up with some two-out runs and two-out rallies. Another throw to first. This time, Thrash is back in plenty of time. West doesn't even bother with trying to lay down a tag. Well, you'll see a lot of respect for the speed of Christian Thrash. Why not? He's already got a stolen base this evening. 0-2 pitch. Just a little bit off the plate. And low. Ball one. One ball and two strikes to count. Once again, Williams will look to the dugout. Refer to the play card on his wrist. Williams kind of peeking over at first. Now he throws. Comes inside on a fastball. It's way too inside for ball two to make the count even. Two to one. Whippets in the lead. Bottom of the third inning. And a long third inning so far. Rusko really getting up on the plate here. Waiting for the 2-2 pitch from Will Williams. Thrash takes off, hit and run in the gap at third. It's off the glove of the third baseman, Hawthorne, and they got a two-out single. Great at bat there by Rusko. It will be a single, hit and run. Runner goes to second. Yeah, no error there because it was not a routine play. Hawthorne had to roll to his left. Even if he gets to that, Rusko gets down the line very quickly. Would have been a tough, tough play to make. But the hit and run put the pressure on the defense there. That'll bring Bailey Powers to the plate. Powers put the ball in play. Reached on an error back in the first inning. A couple of big leads for the runners. Nobody holding them on. First pitch to Powers is a fastball. Catches the corner, I guess. It was one of those very, very close pitches. But yeah, Powers turned on one down the third baseline. It was bobbled by the third baseman, Hawthorne. That was back in the first inning. Williams take a long look back at second base. Power swing, but can't come up with anything there, and it's 0-2. Whippets threatening with runners on first and second. You're in the bottom of the third inning. Now Williams will look back to his second baseman, J.P. Hancock, kind of doing some going through the signals there, calling out the defense. Hancock will walk over to the bag a little bit, play a little bit closer. Now Thrash will take a step back. Fastball off the plate for ball one. Good take there by Powers. We're still continuing here in the longest inning of the night. So Williams digs back in on the dirt at the mound with a long look back at second base. Another long look back. Thrash will inch back to second. There's a swing and strike. The catcher can't hold on to it, but able to get up and throw to third to first for the out. The Whippets threatened but can't score. No runs on one hit, no errors, and two left on base. Through three complete innings, Kosciusko leads it 2-1 over Neshoba Cetnral.
Come on home to Adams Furniture and Appliance. Come on home. Come on home.
This tax season, shop local. Shop at Allen's Furniture and Appliances. Ashley Furniture, Homestretch, Serta, and Sealy Bedding. Allen's also has GE Appliances and the best washer and dryer on the market. Speed Queen. Shop at home. Shop Allen's Furniture and Appliances. Kosciusko and Durant.
Come on home.
Before you begin those do-it-yourself projects outside your home or business, be sure you know where your underground utilities are located. Always call before you dig. One easy phone call to 811 can protect you from injury and expense. Plus, it's the law in Mississippi. Make the call and avoid serious or fatal injury. For more electrical safety tips, contact Central Electric Power Association. Serving you since 1937, an equal opportunity provider and employer.
Boswell Media Sports.
To start the top of the fourth inning, we got a Central Tire Service pitching change. It'll be Aiden Howard, the sophomore, coming in relief of Braxton Smith. They just swapped positions. So you got Howard going to the mound, and you got Braxton Smith heading over to third base. Give you the book on Smith. Smith goes three innings, gives up four hits, walks three, strikes out two, and gives up the one run. So there you go. That's the book on Smith. So it will be the sophomore, Aiden Howard, getting into the pitching for the Rockets. Due up for Neshoba here in the top of the fourth inning, 5, 6, and 7. That'll be DeMarcus West, J.P. Hancock, and Caleb Timms. Fourth innings for Whippets Baseball, presented by Sullivan's Drugs and Gifts. So Howard is a right-hander, sophomore. Get some pitching here. You know, we talked about Smith, you know, coming off of that arm surgery, thinking that he might be on a limited, you know, pitch count here, trying to rehab that arm. And, you know, three good innings for the Whippets. Give up the one run to the first batter of the game. After that, pretty solid outing for the sophomore Smith. As DeMarcus West will come in. West led off the second inning with a single. So he is one for one. Ended up getting thrown out trying to steal. Howard looks in. Now he's going to step off the mound. And he and Kewin couldn't come up with what they wanted. Howard going to work from the stretch with nobody on base. Got him to chase a curveball over to first base. Powers will sit down on it. Take it himself. One pitch, one out. Can't ask for anything better than that. As that goes down three unassisted. And that will bring J.P. Hancock to the plate. Hancock today, 0 for 1. In a fly ball. It was caught by Reggie Carter in right field. There's one hit to third base under the glove of Smith. Rigby able to knock it down. It ain't going to matter anyway. But it will be probably an E5 on that one if I had to score it. So Hancock on first base, but it's two pitches and two swings.
Now batting number 25.
So we got a runner on first base with Caleb Timms, the senior left fielder, coming to the plate. Timms 0 for 1. A little ground out to second. In the second. Ball hit down the line right field, and given Chase's powers, he runs out of real estate pretty quickly, which you will do here at the Whippet Ballpark. No foul territory, and you start getting down the line down in right field. Same thing down in left field. Which is strike. That's three pitches, three swings. So apparently Coach Jones and the Rockets want to be aggressive here with the sophomore Howard on in relief. As Howard will look, runner at first base. Not too big of a lead over at first for Hancock. First time that a Rocket this inning hasn't swung at the ball, and it's a little outside. We never gave you the dimensions of the baseball field here from the Talon County Fairgrounds. Tell you that it goes 315 down the right field line, 305 down the left field line. Give you the rest of them after this. Curveball stays high for ball two. Down the right center field, 345. Left center field, 345. And then in the alleys is 355. The dimensions of the field for you. Also got the new LED lighting system here at the field. You know, if you're familiar with the ones from football, when they do the light show, they did that on the home run that Aiden Howard hit. Runner takes off for second, now throw down to first, and Hancock back in. Hancock had taken off, thought he wasn't going to make it, so he turns around and goes back to first, and able to get back in under the tag, but a quick throw by Kewin and Powers, they almost had him at first base. Pitch was a strike. Makes it two balls and two strikes. So Howard into the stretch. That ball is going to be hitting the gap in right field. And it will get to Reggie Carter. He stops it, keeps it in front of him, and everybody's safe. Yeah, just a little blooper. You had McGee playing a little bit closer to the bag at second, so he wasn't there in the hole to be able to knock that one down. So that'll put runners on first and second with one out. And Ryder White stepping in, the designated hitter. White hit one a long way last time he was at the plate, but it went for naught. It was a long fly ball out to center field. He is a tall drink of water stepping in. Let's see, they got him at 6-3 on the roster. 2-1, Kosciusko clinging to a lead, top of the fourth inning. Howard with a long look back at second. Opens him with a curveball right down the middle. Good looking pitch there from the sophomore Howard. Whippets back at double play depth, hoping to get out, open a double play ball, can get him out of the inning. Smith and Powers going to play an in up close to the grass on the corners. Chant coming from the Neshoba dugout as Howard looks back at second. Jammed him inside. It's fouled off over the first base dugout. Came inside on him. Howard ahead in the count. No balls and two strikes. Whippets need an out right here. Howard hoping to get out of this jam. Coming on in relief of Braxton Smith. Peeks back at second. Rigby covering the bag. That one trying to get him to chase a fastball up and out. But White able to stay off of it as now Howard will look back to get the defensive calls from freshman Braden Rigby playing shortstop. Howard delivers. It's a little slow roller. Rigby's only going to have one play. It'll be at first, and they get him out. Great play on the fielder's choice. The runners will advance, but good play all around. Good play at first. Good play at shortstop. The runners do advance, but there's two outs in the inning now. Yeah, that was just a hit slow enough that Rigby only had the one play at first base. And so we got a first base open, and Logan Collins, the sophomore right fielder, digging in at the plate. Collins was a strikeout victim. Oh, excuse me, we're going to have a pinch hitter. Number two, Espen Jackson digs in, and it is indeed spelled ESPN. So we heard someone tell us that it was called Espen, so that's what we're going to go with. So Espen Jackson steps in. Great name. Great name. But he'll step in to look to Howard. Howard opens up with a fastball that's a little low and off the plate. So let's see. Have him listed as a sophomore. He swings and fouls it off.
You ready, right side?
So you have him listed 5'8", 145, sophomore. So we just know that he's in. We don't know if he's going to come in and play defense out in right field, but he's batting for the right fielder, Logan Collins. 1-1 pitch, fastball high outside for ball two. Normally I'd say with first base open and two outs, it's not the end of the world if you could put him on, but top of the order is coming up, and Davis is 2-for-2. High pop up, that one's going to get out of play. So that makes it two balls and two strikes. Yeah, Jordan Davis has a triple and a double this evening. So you definitely don't want to get Davis back at the plate with the bases loaded. You want to get out of the jam right here if you're the Whippets. They lead it one by one run, 2-1. Howard winds. It's a little slow roller to shortstop. Rigby going to have to charge, throw, get him in time for the out. Good defense there by the Whippets, and they get out of the jam. So out of the top of the first inning, there was no runs on one hit, one error, two left on base. We'll go to the bottom of the fourth with the Whippets leading it 2-1.
Starts at the Atala County Co-op. From your lawn to your flower beds, the Atala County Co-op will make it stand out against the rest with fountain, outdoor furniture, plants, and yard art. It's t-shirt weather, and the Atala County Co-op has a large selection of Old Row, Southern Point, and Strutton Cotton t-shirts and new spring apparel from Ariat and Carhartt. For the perfect drinking experience, grab a brewmate before you head out to the baseball or softball field. The Atala County Co-op, Highway 12 East in Kosciusko.
breakfast, lunch, and dinner is served to you daily at the drive-thru at both Kangaroo Crossing locations in Kosciusko. Bacon, eggs, biscuits for breakfast, chicken tenders, barbecue sandwiches, burgers, and more for lunch and dinner. Drive-thru and take home barbecue meat by the pound with sides of potato salad, baked beans, and coleslaw. All items in store are available for purchase at the drive-thru. Kangaroo Crossing on Veterans Memorial Drive and Highway 12 in Kosciusko.
Boswell Media Sports.
Bottom of the fourth inning, Kosciusko with a 2-1 lead over Neshoba Cetnral. It will be 7, 8, and 9 due up, and it's Aiden Howard who will come to the plate. Howard able to pitch out of a jam in the top half of the inning. He got runners to second and third with two outs and then able to get a ground out. Good defense behind him between Braden Rigby and Bailey Powers over at first base. So Howard can come in and help his own cause here. He's able to put some balls in play, get the Whippets some base runners. He struck out his only other at-bat back in the first inning. So Howard will dig in. It is still Williams on the mound for the Neshoba Cetnral Rockets. He's started the game. So far, he's gone the distance. First pitch to Howard is low and outside for ball one. So far tonight, Williams has struck out four, walked one, and hit one batter. Low ball two. So the junior Williams is kind of rolling pretty quickly here, not taking a lot of time between pitches, dealing with the lefty Aiden Howard. Howard, a lot of contact, but it's going to be foul. One lands over on top of the batting cage to our left. Down towards the student lounge is what it normally is. You get students kind of all here, there, and everywhere this time of year. Other sports they're playing, and that pitch comes inside and low for ball three. Yeah, normally the Whippets have pretty good student section down there, but as we said, you got softball going on, basketball, tennis, you got powerlifting, you got all different kinds of sports that are happening. So they're all. 3-1 pitch, outside, ball four, and Howard draws an opening walk. Big there for the Whippets to get the leadoff runner on. First time this ballgame where they've gotten leadoff runner on. So it sends Reggie Carter to the plate. Carter, the right fielder, senior, struck out back in the second inning. So, let's see, Howard over at first. Carter shows bunt, there's a throw down, and it would have been close, but DeMarquez West couldn't hold on to the ball. A snap throw down to first, and Howard had gotten off the bag, and as I said, great throw, great pop-up throw by Harden. But West just couldn't hold on when he applied the tag. Ball came rolling free. So Whippets maybe trying a little small ball here, get Howard over into scoring position with Carter.
Come on, Reggie. Good job.
0-2. Carter shows bunt again. This time pitch is low. Even the count at one ball and one strike. Fourth innings for Whippet Baseball, brought to you by Sullivan's Drugs and Gifts. Highway 12 in Kosciusko, across from McDonald's. Reggie showing bunt. Once again, pulls it back, and the pitch stays up high in the zone. Ball two. I don't know how many of you watch Whippet football, but Reggie Carter is a wrecking crew on that defensive line. cannot be stopped. Led the team in tackles for loss 3 years in a row. Going to be playing that ball down at Mississippi College. Fastball comes back, finds the inside corner for strike two. Got a few Whippet football players on the baseball team. You got Reggie Carter, Bailey Powers, Barrett Kewen, Andrew Mansell, who's normally, you know, here. That one comes in, hits him. Reggie Carter takes one off the shoulder. And so that'll be runners on first and second. And Braden Rigby, the freshman, digging in, the number nine hitter. That will bring a visit to the mound, and I think we are going to have a pitching change as Coach Jonathan Jones will get the ball from Williams. So we'll step aside for a break, and when we return, we'll tell you who's going to be the new person on the mound and give you all the defensive changes. But as it stands, Whippets with Willers on first and second, and nobody out. It is the bottom of the fourth inning, back in 60 seconds here from Whippet Baseball and Boswell Media Sports.
In your finances, trust the expert staff at Watkins, Ward, and Stafford. Kenny Dungan, Tammy Irving, and staff are here to help their clients achieve financial success and ease your mind when it comes to financial questions for business and personal. Watkins, Ward, and Stafford offers QuickBooks online hosting solutions, payroll, and direct deposits. Watkins, Ward, and Stafford, leading our clients through the next generation of change. South Natchez Street, Kosciusko.
This is physical therapist Haley Kewen at Reliant Physical Therapy. Our staff provides attentive, focused, and compassionate care for every patient to restore you back to your functional level.
Hi, this is Tina McNeil, physical therapist. At Reliant, we offer outpatient physical therapy and post-op care for all ages and circumstances. When you need physical therapy, request Reliant Physical Therapy.
Physical therapist Adam Bell, Haley Kewen, and Tina McNeil, along with assistants Veronica Wolforth and Rebecca Shields Hayden. Transforming lives spiritually and physically. Reliant Physical Therapy in Meigs Plaza on Veterans Memorial Drive, Kosciusko.
Boswell Media Sports.
Pitching change timeout here from the ballpark as Will Williams has been taken out of the ball game. Can't quite make out it is going to be Sam Killens coming in relief of Williams. So Sam Killens, he's a lefty, and we'll have to note any defensive changes. I believe Hawthorne came off the field. So let's see. It looks like that's maybe what happened. I think Williams went to third, and Hawthorne came out of the game. So I think those are the defensive changes that we have to make, as we'll have the number nine hitter step in. That'll be Braden Rigby. So we'll close the book on – or don't close the book on Will Williams because he's got two runners on base. But Rigby steps in. The number nine hitter, Rigby, he had a fly ball. It's a shallow center field, his only other at-bat. So, you know, the lefty, Killens, digging in. Whippets with Aiden Howard on second. The wild pitch going to get away. They're going to throw down to second base as Carter and both Carter and Howard move up.
Let's go.
Rigby showed bunt. Pitch was in the dirt. Runners advance to second and third. So now I got first base open with Rigby at the plate. And top of the order looming large. Whippets in the lead 2-1, bottom of the fourth inning. 1-0 pitch. Swinging strike one for Rigby. So for Williams, he pitched three innings, gave up four hits, walked two, struck out four, gave up two runs, and hit two batters. Can't close the book on the runs just yet because the runner at second and third are his responsibility. Outside on the fastball to Rigby. Makes it two balls and one strike to count. Oh, Rigby, oh. get a sign from his coach, Cole McBride. Killens is a 5'9 sophomore. They have him listed. Now they're going to get a run down. Harden's going to get up and run Aiden Howard back down to the baseline. However, Williams had come down the line, so there was no one really covering the bag. The pitch was a ball. Ball three. Well, Coach Jones is going to come out and talk to the umpire here. Not entirely sure what he's going to be, what he's wanting to ask, but he's going to let the umpire ask him to infer with the, have a conference with one of the midfield umpires. Though not sure what that's about, but hey, the Whippets, oh, they were just trying to figure out the count. That's what it was. A question about the count, but it is three balls and one strike to the freshman, Braden Rigby. Runners on second and third. Big opportunity here for a big inning. The Whippets can would push a little, a couple of the runs across. Pop up in the drifting out of play. So pumped up here over in foul territory by the first base dugout. You got Killens and West both gave chase but ran out of the real estate. But that'll make the count full. So full count, runners on second and third, no outs. Payoff pitch back up the middle, and there's going to be a good play at second base, but he legs it out. So one run comes on the score. Braden Rigby with the single. Still nobody out. Play was over towards the bag at second. Hancock did a good job to get to it, but Rigby with his speed able to get down the line. And that extends the lead for the Whippets. And we go back to the top of the order with Braxton Smith digging in. Smith's got a double, one for two, double and a strikeout. So, runners on the corner, still nobody out. Whippets lead it 3-1. Smith shows butt, stabs at one. He cannot connect. So, 0-1 to count to Braxton Smith. Smith playing third now, started the game at the pitching. Oh, it is Sam Killens. So we'll charge that first run to Williams. He still has one runner over on third base. It's his responsibility. Pitch outside for ball one.
Come on, Braxton.
That evens the count. Fourth innings for Whippet baseball. Presented by Sullivan's Drugs and Gifts. Rigby, not too big of a lead over at first. You got Carter at third. Rigby takes off. Swinging, hit and run. Rigby hits home, and Reggie Carter going to come home. Throw home, gets away from the catcher, and Rigby gets to take third base. So Whippets come away with another run and a runner at third base. Makes it 4-1, and Rigby goes all the way to third. No, nobody out. Should be two balls and one strike to count to Braxton Smith. Yeah, Rigby took off. They tried to get him at second, and they threw him down. And they tried to get Carter coming home, and then when they threw it home, they went over the head of the catcher, Harden, and Rigby was able to take third base. Now we have another conference of officials, umpires, and about what the count should be. Coach Jones seems to think that it should be one ball, two strikes. Coach Jones is going to come and talk a little bit. I had 2-1 in my book. Well, I think it all depends on maybe what that pitch was right there, is what they called it, because it was 1-1, and then on the pitch that Rigby stole on, maybe it was, obviously sometimes we get caught looking elsewhere, don't pay attention to what the pitch was called. And I believe it was two balls. It should be 2 balls and 1 strike. So we'll just kind of wait and see. So it is going to end up being 2 balls and 1 strike to count. As I said, I think it was just on that play right there when the all the action was going elsewhere. But it will remain 2 balls and 1 strike to Braxton Smith. Sam Killens looks at his card. Still nobody out in the inning. A little bit of an off-speed pitch there. Smith chases that one out of the zone to even the count at 2 balls. Now it's 2 balls and 2 strikes. So Rigby over at third. 2-2 pitch. Swinging strike three. First out of the inning. First strikeout for Sam Killens. One down. And Holden McGee steps in. McGee 0-for-2. He's put the ball in play a couple of times. A couple of ground ball outs. One in the third, one in the first. So we got a time called. Oh, the umpire's kind of switching positions there in the field. So that's all we're waiting on. Pitch outside, ball one. You got the lefty Killens, now you got the right-handed McGee at the plate. Swinging strike one. Whippets have plated 2 in the inning, and they have 1 just 90 feet away. As the count will even up at 1 ball and 1 strike. That was a high one that McGee chopped at it and caught a piece of it and fouled it off right off the plate there. And I believe that one might have caught Harden. Oh, he's going to take a little bit of a break there, right there. And walk it off as the infield comes in and gives him some time behind the plate to, as I said, kind of walk things off. Well, now everybody's back. And the umpire, during that, cleaned off the plate. A lot of times you see that where pitcher or catcher takes one below the belt, and they'll give him some time to fix things. McGee swings and a high one and fouls it back. Whippets with a 3-run lead, trying to extend it. Only one down here in the inning. They were able to get, when the inning started, with 2 walks, and then it was a single by Braden Rigby that drove in a run. Ball hit into shallow left center field. Is it going to get down? It is. It's in front of Timms. Rigby's going to come around to score. McGee's hoofing it for second, and he's in. It's a double for Holden McGee, and the Whippets have extended the lead. So give McGee the RBI double.
number 11.
And it brings up Benny Powell to the plate. Powell, he is 1-for-2, a home run, solo shot. This is the third at-bat of the season for the Whippets. Powell, the junior, sent one over the left field wall. He's got an opportunity here to extend the lead for his team if he's able to find a gap somewhere. Got the lefty. Killen's looking back. He's going to show bunt, and he lays it down the third baseline. It's going to roll foul. Just a little bit foul. Boy, that one was hugging the line all the way down towards the bag at third and then just rolls foul. If that one stays fair, I don't even think a third baseman tries to throw Benny Powell out at first because how fast he is. So runner on second base, 0-1 the count to Powell. Whippets with a 5-1 lead. Four of those have come in this inning. Killen going to fake the throw back to second. Nobody covering the bag, so McGee slides in. As I said, there's no one really there to throw to. Killen didn't start this inning, but you can close the book on Williams. Turns on one down the line, but saves the left of the bag foul. Powell down in the count. No balls and two strikes. So, yeah, close the book on Will Williams. He does get charged with those two runs after he got him on base. So, three innings pitched, four hits, two walks, four strikeouts, four runs, two hit batsmen. Powell is granted time. Harvin going to sit up outside. Powell swings, once again fouls it off. Chops it down the line at third base. We'll have another 0-2 pitch coming to the Whippet center fielder. Benny Powell joined the Whippet football team this fall. It was his first year playing football. Played wide receiver for Coach Casey Orr. Had a few catches in the season. Good athlete. 0-2 pitch gets him to chase it, and he caught a little bit of it. Able to get just a hair of it to stay alive at the plate. Mentioned baseball players playing football. The coaches for all the sports have been able to kind of get some of the guys to come out. You got Mansell, who played football for the first year this year for the Whippets. Same thing with Benny Powell. The football team also got a few basketball players, like Jabri Pierce and Marion Riley, to come out. So a lot of the guys playing multiple sports. 0-2 pitch to Powell in the dirt. It's blocked up nicely by R.B. Harden. Otherwise, McGee probably would have been able to get over to third base. But that is just ball one in the at-bat. Powell had been staying alive at the plate. Oh, Killens will take another long look back at second base. Powell, another one hit deep into left field. It's drifting back. It lands at the base of the wall. Here comes McGee. Powell stands at second with a double, and he is jacked. Doing a little dance out there at second base was Benny Powell. So that is his second RBI of the game. Let's see, McGee comes around to score. Extends the Whippets lead. 6-1. And it'll be Baird Kewin coming to the plate. Another one of those Whippet football players we've been talking about. Kewin today has not registered an official at bat. He took one between the shoulder blades. His first bat, and he walked back in the third. And he sends that one into the gap at left center field. It's going to roll all the way to the wall.
going to be back-to-back doubles for the Whippets. Kewin with an RBI. And the Whippets keep extending their lead. Still only one out in the inning. It's Christian Thrash will step in to run.
Now batting number 27, John Wyatt Rusko.
John Wyatt Rusko, he's had a big night. He's 2 for 2. Singled and scored in the first, drove in a run, he drove in a run, and then he had a single in the third inning. 7-1, Kosciusko leads at bottom of the fourth inning. He shows bunt, lays it down third baseline, it rolls foul. The lefty. And a lefty-lefty matchup here. Rusko, a junior. Whippets having a big inning. Already got 5 runs, and they got one in scoring position out at second base. A little bit low. Inside, ball one, count evens. Griffiths, all the defensive plays out at shortstop. As all the Rockets will read their cards on the wrist. Killens with a look. There's a breaking ball that catches the outside corner for strike two. Whippets are in action today and tomorrow. If you didn't hear, you haven't read the Twitter feed, or you weren't listening earlier when we mentioned it, that the game tomorrow has moved up to 4 o'clock. Got some weather coming in. So the varsity game's going to be at 4. And there's a called strike 3. That one's a breaking ball inside corner.
Come on, buddy. Let's hit it hard.
That will send Bailey Powers to the plate.
Number 15, Bailey Powers.
That's the second strikeout of the game for Sam Killens, who's on in relief. He didn't face the first two batters in the inning, and Bailey Powers steps in.
Hit it hard somewhere. Let's go.
Powers 0 for 2, struck out in the third. He did reach on an error in the first inning. That one comes in high for ball one. This is the ninth Whippet batter to come to the plate in the inning. You got Howard, who led off the inning on deck. Killens looks back at second and going to throw back as Hancock drifted over to the bag, but Christian Thrash able to get it back in well in time.
Let's go, Big Pig.
7-1. Kosciusko trying to keep the big inning going. They've had 2 walks and 4 hits. Powers fouls off, chops one over to the softball field to our right. Yeah, as we mentioned, the game tomorrow, 4 o'clock, first pitch for against East Webster, the varsity game. And then the JV, weather permitting, they would play the JV game after that. Just trying to get some in before the weather gets here, which can be tricky this time of year. Powers swings. Catches a little piece of it. Makes it 1-2 strikes the count. Approaching the 2-hour mark of the game. First pitch was at 7:05, 9:01, 9:02 right now. Harbin gonna set up outside.
1-2 pitch in the dirt. Ball two to make the count even.
Let's go.
Coach McBride put the card down. Doing some coaching down the third baseline is Christian Thrash looking over, getting the signal. Harden going to set up outside again. High ball three, count goes full.
Now let's go, let's go.
Good job by Powers. Battle back here and run the count full. Whippets with a 7-1 lead. Got the chant going off to our right. See some temperature dropping here at the ballpark. Payoff pitch is hit, and it's going to be a line drive caught by Griffiths at shortstop. But the Whippets are able to open the ball game up. They get 5 runs on 4 hits, no errors, and 1 left on base through 4 complete innings. Kosciusko with a 6-run lead, 7-1.
Here's something I bet you don't know. You could go to college for free. Do you have a 20 on your ACT?
Yes. Whoa. Wait. So my tuition is free? Where?
Home CC. Yes, every word you just heard is absolutely true. Goodman, Kosciusko, Grenada, Ridgeland, Yazoo City, online. Does not matter.
Why in the world would Holmes Community College offer free tuition with a 20 on the ACT?
Simple. At Holmes, we don't want you drowning in college debt the rest of your life.
You know, I have heard students with associate degrees from Holmes often make more money than 4-year students with bachelor and master degrees.
True. Plus, at Holmes, you get 3-day weekends. So there's that.
Sweet.
So now you know. Your tuition is free with a 20 on your ACT at Holmes CC.
No place like Holmes.
Holmes Community College.
Boswell Media Sports.
And welcome back to the Itala County Fairgrounds. Whippets have a 5 spot in the bottom of the 4th inning to take a 7-1 lead over Neshoba Cetnral. And let's see, it was 2 walks that got things started, and then a single by Braden Rigby. Then back-to-back doubles. It was 3 doubles in a row. Had McGee, Powell, and Kewen with the doubles. And that's how the Whippets were able to get their runs. They will send Aiden Howard back to the mound, who had come on in relief for Braxton Smith. So it will be the top of the order. 1, 2, and 3 due up. And it's the dangerous Jordan Davis. Davis is 2 for 2, a triple and a double. The first time he's faced off against Aiden Howard. We told you at the top of the broadcast that Jordan Davis, one of 4 Rockets headed to play JUCO baseball. Davis going down to Perkinston. He'll be a bulldog for Mississippi Gulf Coast. He steps in to work against Howard. First pitch is hit to Rigby, plays it back. It'll be a long throw over. Good play. 1 pitch, 1 out. Good defense by Rigby in the hole there to throw out the speedy Davis.
Now batting number 6, Sanders Griffin.
It must be an aggressive approach for Coach Jones, because since Aiden Howard's been in the game, a lot of first pitch swings for this Neshoba Central Ball Club. Sanders Griffiths steps in. He's 0-1. Lays down a good bunt, and they're going to let it roll foul. Great, great play by Kewen, Smith, and Howard. That was going to be trouble if it stayed fair, but Kewen and Howard both letting it roll down and roll foul. So all it is a long strike for Sanders Griffiths. That pitch is outside for ball one. Makes the count even. Howard, one of those pitchers that works from the stretch even when there's nobody on base. That one's low for ball two. And some pitchers just like to do that. Some pitchers don't feel comfortable working from the windup. Yeah, so they'll throw from the stretch all the time. It took a little bit off of that one. I guess it was must have been a little bit low, as it was right down the middle. 3-1 the count to Griffiths. High pop up on the infield. Howard gonna call off. And Howard was ran into by Griffiths, and so they're gonna call it foul ball or call it out. Should be out. So, yeah, Howard and Griffiths collide, and now they will call it. Yeah, Griffiths was running down the line, and Howard was trying to make a play, and they collided. Coach Jones is going to come talk to him about it, and he's going to talk about the play. As it stands, it will be interference. Coach Jones so we're going to wait and see. Got another appeal to the umpire in the field. So we're just kind of waiting and see. As I said, Coach Jones appealing to the umpires. They would call it out. So basically Aiden Howard was running, or Griffiths is running down the line. Aiden Howard runs over to make the catch, and Griffiths and Howard collide. Obviously, the fielder has the right to the ball, and Griffiths was running inside the line, so it'd be runner's interference, which would make the runner out because the fielder has the right to play the ball. I'm not sure Coach Jones may be arguing that it's a foul ball or something of the sort. But it will remain an out. Coach Jones doesn't like the call, but it will remain an out. Griffiths is out, and that's two down in the inning.
Now batting number 16, R.B. Harden.
That'll bring up R.B. Harden to the plate. Harden 0 for 1 today. He walked in the third and struck out in the first. Howard delivers, and it's a ball low outside. Two outs in the inning. Fifth innings for Whippet. Baseball are presented by Watkins, Ward, and Stafford. Inside, ball two. Two balls, no strikes, the count to Harden. And the senior catcher. Some vocalization from the Rockets dugout. Hard hit ball, left field, drifting, foul. Little hit beyond the Whippets locker room. Would have been trouble if it had been fair. It's just a long, long strike against Harden. Harden turned on one. And see, it says 305 down the left field line. That one was probably 305. It was just foul. Well, that was a long, long one. Harden couldn't keep it in the field of play. Well, Howard and Kewin will work to get some signs. Pitch a little off the plate. Makes the count three balls and one strike. Allen's Furniture brings you our online streams. That's the video stream on the Boswell Media YouTube channel, or if you're driving in your vehicle listening somewhere. Pitch is called strike two to make the count even. Thought it was a little elevated, but yeah, if you have the stream on, you know, you're driving in your vehicle somewhere out of our listening area, you got the Breezy 101 app Allen's Furniture brings you all those online streams. Payoff pitch. Low outside for ball four. So that's a two-out walk. That is the first walk issued by Aiden Howard since he's come into the ballgame.
Number 13, Will Williams.
Will Williams stepping in. He's the third baseman. Now, he had been the pitcher, but he moved over to the third base after that last big inning for the Whippets. Howard sends him one right down the middle for strike one. I'm picking up the Wilson Williams chant. His name on the roster is Will Williams, but the Neshoba dugout is chanting Wilson Williams. You pick up when you're this close to the field. Breaking ball a little bit high and out for ball one. One ball, one strike. You got Harden over at first with a decent lead being held on by Bailey Powers. High pop up, drifting out of play. Is anyone going to make a play? No. So Kewen was the closest one, but it drifted out of play right there by the Whippet dugout and make it one ball and two strikes the count. Kewen thought that one might stay in play, and it didn't get out of play by much, but it was right there along the netting. Some of those premium seats, those chair backs you have on reserve seating. Harden takes off, hit and run. Williams fouls it off. He was able to reach out and just keep that one. Harden got a pretty good jump. So he might have been saying, I don't know, you don't often think of the catcher as being the fastest guy on the team, but Harden, he got a decent lead. So one ball, two strikes. Another pitch coming as Howard leans in to get a sign from Kewen. He'll peek over Harden, who inches back towards the bag at first. High, quick throw down to first. Safe. Good throw from Kewen, but Harden just back under the tag. Boy, they're close. Kewen and Powers on the same wavelength right there. They're going to catch somebody creeping off the bag a little too far before the season's over. Pitch was outside, so it makes the count even at 2-2. Howard will step off the mound. Kind of gather himself. Aiden Howard. Aiden Howard, a young man, when he was in the junior high, you know, winning a throw and catch hitting competition. One of those Major League Baseball ones. He went out to Houston to play. Swinging strike three. Strikeouts presented by Dickerson Petroleum. And that'll do it for the Rockets in the third. No runs, no hits, no errors. One left on base. We'll step aside for 60 seconds. Kosciusko leads it by six as we go to the bottom of the fifth inning.
When an electrical shortage in your office causes extensive smoke and water damage, or that musty odor indicates you might have a mold problem, you need a lot more than just help cleaning up. That's why ServPro Northeast Deltalands is the authority when disaster strikes. We offer all the cleanup and construction services to take your home or business to good as new and as soon as possible. So no matter what happens, there's just one call you need to make. Call ServPro Northeast Deltalands at 662-289-7473 to see how we can help you back to like it never even happened. Franchises are independently owned and operated.
When it comes to insurance, one size does not fit all. At Alpha, the Chris Coleman Agency in Kosciusko, knowing the customer and their individual needs is what we pride ourselves on. We know how important it is for everyone to have the peace of mind that your insurance coverages are tailored for you. Our team recognizes your life and your unique needs. That is why we provide you with numerous insurance options, an easy claim process, and personal attention that is second to none, all at one location without breaking the bank. Call us today at 662-289-1024 or visit us at 235 North Madison Street off the square in Kosciusko. At Alpha, the Chris Coleman Agency, we guarantee the right fit for you and all of your insurance needs.
Boswell Media Sports.
6-run lead for your Kosciusko Whippets to start the bottom of the fifth inning. And due up for the Whippets in the bottom of the inning will be 7, 8, and 9. Scheduled to be Aiden Howard, Reggie Carter, and Braden Rigby. So we'll see if those guys are the ones that end up coming to the plate. But 7, 8, and 9, Howard is 0 for 1. He struck out in the first, and he walked and scored in the fourth inning.
Now batting number 25, Aiden Howard.
Well, as we were going off the going into the break, the top of the inning, his first pitch from Killens is off the plate for ball one. We told you that Aiden Howard, when he was in junior high, won a regional so it's a punt, pass, and kick competition, but for baseball. I'm not sure what you call it. Well, there's a strike to Howard. But he won a regional, went out to Houston, Texas for the Astros and competed in the competition out there. So even at a young age, Howard was showing some prowess when it comes to hitting. And right there, he lays off of one. And so a breaking ball outside for ball two. Two balls, one strike to count. Howard, the lefty. Well, another lefty-lefty matchup. Hard hit ball into center field. Jordan Davis going to roll over to his right. A couple of steps and make the catch for out number one. So that brings up Reggie Carter to the plate. Carter is 0 for 1. He struck out and he was hit by a pitch his last at bat. Carter came around to score in that big fourth inning where the Whippets played at 5 runs, which gave them their 7-1 lead that they hold right now. Carter looks at one in the dirt for ball one. Carter swings at that one, fouls it off towards the softball field. Fifth innings for Whippet Baseball, brought to you by Watkins Ward and Stafford. It's tax time. They'll take care of your taxes for you as the Whippets try to take care of this one. And Carter swings. I think he got a little piece of it, a little of that high fastball that's hard to lay off, but I said he got a piece of it, but not enough. That one's low, bounces off the dirt to even the count at 2-2. R.B. Harden will walk the ball back to his pitcher, Sam Killens, who's on in relief. He didn't start the game. He came in the fourth inning as Will Williams started the game, and then he started that fourth inning by walking two batters. And so after that, Coach Jones went to the bullpen and brought in Sam Killens. Carter looks at a called strike three. That is the third strikeout of the game for Sam Killens. And it'll send Braden Rigby to the plate.
Now batting number 5.
The freshman Rigby's had a good game. He singled and drove in a run. Single score, drove in the run in the fourth, and some good plays out at shortstop. So he's 1-for-2. He had a line drive, was caught in center field for his first at bat. But, the number 9 hitter. Looks at a fastball that's way high for ball one. There's a curve ball that finds its way into the strike zone for ball one. Whippet's got a young team here. There's 3 seniors on the club. As Rigby swings and sends one foul. Oh. 1-2 pitch coming to Braden Rigby. Swinging strike three. Back-to-back strikeouts will end the inning, and the Whippets go down in order. No runs, no hits, no errors, and nobody left on base. Through five complete innings, Kosciusko leads it over Neshoba 7-1.
Mornings at Wendy's are pretty sweet. Our homestyle French toast sticks, honey butter chicken biscuit, or maple bacon chicken croissant are so much more than just savory. That sweet, sweet syrup, perfect for dipping or drizzling. And that sweet honey butter, oh, it's that kind of breakfast. With our homestyle French toast sticks, honey butter chicken biscuit, or maple bacon chicken croissant, waking up has never been sweeter. Choose wisely. Choose Wendy's breakfast.
At participating U.S. Wendy's during breakfast hours.
Renaissance Insurance is your neighborhood insurance partner. Renaissance Insurance makes you feel at home with your home insurance. When you hit the road, Renaissance Insurance makes sure it's with the right auto coverage tailored for you. Renaissance Insurance takes the hassle out of sorting through business insurance. One stop, complete coverage. Call Robbie Robertson or Bradley Tyler at 662-289-4621. Renaissance Insurance. Court Square, Kosciusko.
Boswell Media Sports.
Top of the sixth inning, six-run lead for Kosciusko, 7-1 here on opening night from the Itala County Fairgrounds. Breck Riley with you. You got Donald back at the studio on Golf Course Road. If you want to see what games we're broadcasting, get on over to breezynews.com. You'll find the broadcast schedule there. It's not every game. We got a 10 or 11 game schedule that we put together. And you'll be able to see it. I believe our next scheduled broadcast is on Tuesday. Where the Whippets will host, or are scheduled to host, the Jaguars of Madison Central. So home game will be on Tuesday. And then we got a game the next Tuesday, I believe, against Northeast Lauderdale. Be welcoming in a former Kosciusko Whippet, Brock McKnight, the head coach of the Trojans. And then after that, we'll go on the road in the return trip to Philadelphia to take on this Neshoba Central Rocket team. So that's a quick look at our next few broadcast games. Of course, you can keep up with everything during the week with the Surf Pro Coaches Show. Join me and Coach Cole McBride Thursday mornings during the breakfast show. Get all of the updates and info you need on the Kosciusko Whippets. Aiden Howard's first pitch to the leadoff batter, DeMarcus West, is low outside for ball one. Baird Kewin requests that the umpire kind of clean off the plate a little bit. So DeMarcus West is 1-for-2. He singled in the second, and he grounded out to first in the fourth inning. So it's Aiden Howard still on the bump for the Whippets. Curveball. Comes, catches the inside corner for strike one. One pitch. There's a strike on the inside corner. Aiden Howard has come in relief. Is Braxton Smith, a fellow sophomore. That one's just a little bit outside. Boy, Barrett Kewin thought he was ready to pop up and throw it around the infield, but that's been just a little bit of an outside. 2-2 pitch. There's a little slow roller. Rigby going to play it off a hop. Quick throw in time. Good defense up the middle. Braden Rigby really fielding it out there at shortstop. 6-3 put out. One down in the inning.
Now batting number 11.
So the one out, it sends Hancock to the plate. J.P. Hancock 0-for-2 today. He flew out to right field. He reached on an error in the fourth. First pitch to Hancock is a little bit high and outside for ball one. It's the top of the sixth innings for Whippet Baseball, presented by Alpha Insurance, a Chris Coleman agency just off the square here in downtown Kosciusko. 1-0 offering is right down the middle for strike one. Evens up the count. Whippets with a 7-1 lead, top of the sixth inning. Stick around for our Wendy's post game. We'll name our Autumn Ridge Dental player of the game. Give you a game recap, stat recap. Hard hit ball in the center field. Benny Powell only asked to move about two steps. Had him shaded perfectly. And that's two outs. That will bring up Caleb Timms, the senior left fielder. He's 1-for-2. He's got a single. He singled in the fourth inning. He grounded out back in the second inning. Aiden Howard opens him up with a fastball inside corner, strike one. We've got a couple of sophomores dealing some innings for the Whippets here. We mentioned just a young team with only three seniors. Hard hit ball to left field. Rusko is going to get it. He had to track it down and bring it in. So that's a 1-2-3 inning for the Whippets as well. No runs, no hits, no errors, nobody left on base. Go to the bottom of the sixth inning. The Whippets lead it by 6-7-1.
Beauty of Spring starts at the Itala County Co-op. From your lawn to your flower beds, the Itala County Co-op will make it stand out against the rest with fountain, outdoor furniture, plants, and yard art. It's t-shirt weather, and the Itala County Co-op has a large selection of Old Row, Southern Point, and Strut and Cotton t-shirts, and new spring apparel from Ariat and Carhartt. For the perfect drinking experience, grab a brewmate before you head out to the baseball or softball field. The Itala County Co-op, Highway 12 East in Kosciusko.
Breakfast, lunch, and dinner is served to you daily at the drive-thru at both Kangaroo Crossing locations in Kosciusko. Bacon, eggs, biscuits for breakfast, chicken tenders, barbecue sandwiches, burgers, and more for lunch and dinner. Drive through and take home barbecue meat by the pound with sides of potato salad, baked beans, and coleslaw. All items in store are available for purchase at the drive-thru. Kangaroo Crossing on Veterans Memorial Drive and Highway 12 in Kosciusko.
Boswell Media Sports.
The Whippets will send the top of the order to the plate here at the bottom of the sixth inning. It is 1-2-3. Braxton Smith, Holden McGee, and Benny Powell. We appreciate you for tuning in here on opening night of baseball. We're going to have Kosciusko Whippets softball also this weekend. The Whippet, Lady Whippets going on the road. Play over in Lake, a tournament in Lake. They're going to take on Enterprise tomorrow, and then home game will be next. First official home game going to be on Tuesday against Choctaw County. So they got the tournament in Lake this weekend, and then your Lady Whippets will be here. We'll have that twofer on Tuesday here. You'll have Madison Central here against the baseball team, and you'll have Whippet softball taking on Choctaw County. So those are always fun. Should be a big, big crowd here at the ballpark on Tuesday. I think that's that'll be the 20th on Tuesday. But hey, Whippets are trying to close one out here and get the first win of the season against their rivals from Neshoba Cetnral. It'll be Braxton Smith at the plate. He is 1-for-3. He's got two strikeouts and a double. First pitch swinging, it'll be fouled. Out of play. Smith started the game as the pitcher. Right now he's playing third base. We mentioned a young team. The three seniors, Andrew Mansell, Reggie Carter, and Braxton Ray. Whippets with a lot of young talent here. Pitches up in the zone. Ball one to make it an even count. Got some action going on over in the bullpen. That's a Central Tire Service pitching update. I see someone, Whippet maybe bringing in another arm, another closer. Smith looks at strike two, which is a fastball right down the middle of the plate. One ball and two strikes, the count to Braxton Smith. Still Sam Killens, the lefty. No, excuse me, that's a new pitcher in the ballgame. Didn't make that note. As there's a curveball that catches the outside corner, and it's called strike three. That is Griffiths that came in to pitch. Did not make that note in my book there. So Griffiths comes in to pitch as Holden McGee pops one up on the infield, and it will be caught at second base by Hancock, who came in on the grass to make the catch, and that's two quick outs. And so now Benny Powell is going to come in. Benny Powell is the pitcher who had been warming up. When we mentioned that pitching update, Central Tire Service update, Benny Powell had been taking some reps out there in the bullpen. So maybe Benny Powell going to come in to close things out as the pitch from Griffiths is inside for a ball. But we're trying to make the defensive changes. It looks like Griffiths came to pitch and Will Garner came in to play shortstop. I believe that's the case. You get these defensive changes, then exactly kind of hard to see as that pitch is low outside, ball two. The count to Powell. Powell today is had a good day. Two for three. Pitch way outside, ball three, 3-0. Let's see, Powell has a double, a home run, two runs driven in, and a run scored. So, yeah, Powell, he's had a pretty good day so far. Well, imagine he'd keep the bat on his shoulder right here with the 3-0 count. Wind and delivers, and this is want to happen. It comes right down the middle for strike one. As we mentioned, stick around for the Wendy's post game. I'll have a quick wrap up on this one. And maybe the Whippets can send the home fans home with the win as Griffiths has battled back to make it a full count. Three balls and two strikes to Powell. Powell trying to extend the inning, give the Whippets a few more insurance runs. Little chopper to third base. It's played off the hips of Williams, and Powell able to leg it out. Oh, Benny Powell reaching base with two outs.
Now batting number seven, Barrett Hewitt.
Probably go down as an error. Let's see what the officials, if they scored here on the app. Yep, they will call that an error, E5. So brings up Baird Kewin. Kewin today, he's got a double and a run driven in. He's reached base all three times he's been at the plate. He has a walk and he was hit by a pitch. He swings and comes up empty on the first one. Oh, Kewin. Like I said, trying to give the Whippets a few insurance runs. He got a speedy Benny Powell at first base. Pitches out the plate. It's going to get past Harden. Powell going to send up at second base. Evens the count at 1-1. Well, now you got any ball through the infield, you're probably going to be sending Powell home to score. As Sanders Griffiths looks back to J.P. Hancock getting those defensive signals out at second base. Powell, decent lead. That one's hit right to the shortstop. Garner, who bobbles it, but he'll throw and collect it in time to get the out. So Whippets strand one. No runs, no hits, one error, and one left on base. We'll go to the final inning of play. Whippets lead at 7-1.
Handling your finances, trust the expert staff at Watkins, Ward, and Stafford. Kenny Dungan, Tammy Irving, and staff are here to help their clients achieve financial success and ease your mind when it comes to financial questions for business and personal. Watkins, Ward, and Stafford offers QuickBooks online hosting solutions, payroll, and direct deposits. Watkins, Ward, and Stafford, leading our clients through the next generation of change. South Natchez Street, Kosciusko.
This is physical therapist Haley Kewen at Reliant Physical Therapy. Our staff provides attentive, focused, and compassionate care for every patient to restore you back to your functional level.
Hi, this is Tina McNeil, physical therapist. At Reliant, we offer outpatient physical therapy and post-op care for all ages and circumstances. When you need physical therapy, request Reliant Physical Therapy.
Physical therapists Adam Bell, Haley Kewen, and Tina McNeil, along with assistants Veronica Wolforth and Rebecca Shields Hayden. Transforming lives spiritually and physically. Reliant Physical Therapy in Meigs Plaza on Veterans Memorial Drive, Kosciusko.
Boswell Media Sports.
The Whippets have a six-run lead as we start the final inning of play. It will be Aiden Howard on to close it out. The Whippets did have Benny Powell up in the bullpen taking some warm-up tosses. And I imagine they'll let Howard go. If he gives up a runner, a base runner or two, he might see the Whippets go to Benny Powell, bring in the junior center fielder. But as it stands now, you let the sophomore Howard keep it rolling. 7-1 as the Neshoba Cetnral Rockets come back to the plate. It will be 8-9-1. Now that's the order. The number nine hitter has been somewhat different every time. We'll have to wait and see what air. But it does look like Ryder White is going to lead things off. He's 0-2. Hit a pop up into the outfield, and he grounded into a fielder's choice in the fourth inning.
Batting number seven for the Rockets, Ryder White.
Barrett Kewen going to walk out and talk to his pitcher. You can close the book on Sam Killens, who was the pitcher for the Rockets, as Sanders Griffiths had come in that last inning. Well, the first pitch is grounded back to Howard, who will throw over to first for the out. One pitch, one out. We told you that the Rockets got way more aggressive when Howard came in. A lot of first pitch swings. You know, scouting report against Howard.
For the Rockets, number eight,
so we will have another different player, Xavier Benn, come in to bat for this number nine spot. First pitch swinging right field. Reggie Carter on the run. He's going to make the catch. Two pitches, two outs. We'll go back to the top of the order. Go ahead and tell you this real quickly before the inning's over. Reliant Physical Therapy brings you seventh innings for Whippets baseball.
Jordan Davis
steps in, the leadoff batter. He is 2-for-3. He's got a triple, a double, and a ground out. He scored the lone run. He tripled to start the game and then scored on a wild pitch. Lefty will work against Howard. Pitches inside for ball one. You knew that he was going to be taken all the way right there because they didn't want the three pitch, three outs. So he's going to be taken right there all the way. One oh pitch comes inside corner, fastball, strike one. So Aiden Howard winds, or doesn't really wind, working from the stretch even with nobody on, and that stays off the plate for ball two. 2-1 the count to Jordan Davis. Got him to chase the high fastball for strike two. Got a Whippets one strike away from getting that opening day win. So Howard and Kewin working together on some signs, taking a long, long time, and Davis, as you'd expect, to ask for time right there. Howard steps back in. Delivers, swinging strike three, and that will do it. That's a Dickerson Petroleum strikeout, and the Whippets get the win 7-1. We're going to step aside for an extended break. When we come back, we will wrap things up. Name our player of the game. Big win for the Whippets here on opening night, 7-1.
Something I bet you don't know. You could go to college for free. Do you have a 20 on your ACT?
Yes. Whoa, 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 whoa. Wait. So my tuition is free? Where?
Home CC. Yes, every word you just heard is absolutely true. Goodman, Kosciusko, Grenada, Ridgeland, Yazoo City, online. Does not matter.
Why in the world would Holmes Community College offer free tuition with a 20 on the ACT?
Simple. At Holmes, we don't want you drowning in college debt the rest of your life.
You know, I have heard students with associate degrees from Holmes often make more money than four-year students with bachelor and master degrees.
True. Plus, at Holmes, you get three-day weekends. So there's that.
Sweet.
So now you know, your tuition is free with a 20 on your ACT at Holmes CC.
No place like Holmes.
Holmes Community College.
What moves you down the road and through the woods? Central Tire Service and Central Trailer Sales with utility trailers in all sizes and truck beds. Central Tire Sales can customize to your specifications. Central Tire Service puts your life in motion with tires engineered to last for your ATV and vehicle. A full service mechanic and tire shop. Central Tire Service and Central Trailer Sales across from Prairie Farms and Kosciusko.
Your pharmacist is more than someone who fills your prescriptions. Your pharmacist helps you understand what medications you're taking. Your pharmacist makes sure your insurance is filed correctly. And your pharmacist answers any other questions you may have regarding your medications.
Hi, I'm Rob Pickle, registered pharmacist and owner of Pickle's Drugstore. It is my goal to give you the personal attention you need to improve your health and well-being. My staff and I are here to serve you.
Pickle's Drugstore, your hometown pharmacy, on the east side of the square in Kosciusko.
Renaissance Insurance is your neighborhood insurance partner. Renaissance Insurance makes you feel at home with your home insurance. When you hit the road, Renaissance Insurance makes sure it's with the right auto coverage tailored for you. Renaissance Insurance takes the hassle out of sorting through business insurance. One stop, complete coverage. Call Robbie Robertson or Bradley Tyler at 662-289-4621. Renaissance Insurance, Court Square, Kosciusko.
Wendy's without the Wendy's app is like Nugs without the sauce. Or a Frosty without the fries. Or a hamburger without the fresh beef.
No!
Level up.
Get the app to order ahead, order delivery, earn free food, and get app-exclusive offers. One app, all the Wendy's.
Offer for a limited time at participating Wendy's. Terms apply. App registration required. Fresh beef available in contiguous U.S., Alaska, and Canada.
Boswell Media Sports.
Welcome into the Wendy's postgame, and it's a big win for the Whippets here on opening night, 7-1 over the Rockets of Neshoba Cetnral, and a great, great pitching performance by two Whippets. So give you a look at the numbers there. Braxton Smith goes three innings, gives up four hits, walks three, strikes out two, gives up one run. Aiden Howard on in relief. Four innings pitch. It was one hit, one walk, and two strikeouts. So that's tell of the tape for the Whippet pitching staff for the visitors from Neshoba Cetnral. It was Will Williams who got the start. He goes three innings, gives up four hits, walks two, strikes out four, gives up four runs, and he hit two batters. Sam Killens comes in, two innings, gives up four hits, strikes out four with three runs, and it was Sanders Griffiths who pitched that final inning for the Rockets. He did not give up anything. No runs, no hits, no walks. He did have one base runner who reached on an error. But the Rockets got their one run at the very beginning of the game. It was Jordan Davis who led off with a triple to right field and then scored on the very next batter on a wild pitch. After that, Whippets settled in, and they were able to cruise to see the Whippets tied it up in the bottom of the inning on a solo home run by Benny Powell, third at batter of the season. Benny Powell with the solo home run. After that, Barrett Cuen was hit by a pitch. And then on a stolen base by Christian Thrash, John Wyatt Rusko drives in the run to take a 2-1 lead. We stayed at 2-1 for a while until the Whippets got a big fourth inning. It started off as two batters were walked, and then there was a pitching change. After that, you had three doubles in a row. You had Holden McGhee, Benny Powell, and Baird Cuen with three doubles, and that really opened up the game. That was five runs, fourth inning. And that's where the scoring would end. After that, the Whippets went down in order. So your final 7-1, Kosciusko wins it. We're going to step aside for one more break. When we come back, we'll name our Autumn Ridge Dental Player of the Game.
When handling your finances, trust the expert staff at Watkins, Ward, and Stafford. Kenny Dungan, Tammy Irving, and staff are here to help their clients achieve financial success and ease your mind when it comes to financial questions for business and personal. Watkins, Ward, and Stafford offers QuickBooks online hosting solutions, payroll, and direct deposits. Watkins, Ward, and Stafford, leading our clients through the next generation of change. South Natchez Street, Kosciusko.
Breakfast, lunch, and dinner is served to you daily at the drive-thru at both Kangaroo Crossing locations in Kosciusko. Bacon, eggs, biscuits for breakfast, chicken tenders, barbecue sandwiches, burgers, and more for lunch and dinner. Drive-thru and take home barbecue meat by the pound with sides of potato salad, baked beans, and coleslaw. All items in store are available for purchase at the drive-thru. Kangaroo Crossing on Veterans Memorial Drive and Highway 12 in Kosciusko.
Have you been putting off coming to the dentist lately? Hello, I'm Dr. Adam Middleton from Autumn Ridge Dental in Kosciusko. We know life has been busy and routines have changed for many. However, we do not want you to neglect health. We are treating patients with a mindset we have always held, that proper, regular, preventive care can help keep your mouth healthy and functioning properly. We want all our patients to have a smile they can be proud of. Please call us at 662-289-7076 for an appointment. Come see us, and we will give you something to smile about.
Hello, this is Dr. Paul Gundy of Autumn Ridge Dental, and we salute the Kosciusko Whippet Player of the Game. And now that's something to smile about.
Boswell Media Sports.
Lot to smile about for the Kosciusko Whippets with a 7-1 win over Neshoba Cetnral here on the opening night of the baseball season in 2024. And hey, you got a lot of guys that could be Autumn Ridge Dental Player of the Game. You take a look at someone like Braxton Smith and Aiden Howard. Both those young men did great. Two sophomores on the mound combining to give up just five hits and only one run with four strikeouts. You also had Baird Cuen, who reached base almost every time he got to the plate. He was hit by a pitch. He was walked. He had a double, drove in a run. Braden Rigby had a big game. He had a single and a run driven in and a run scored, and he played great defensively. But I think it all starts with someone who set the tone, who had a great game, and that would be the junior center fielder Benny Powell. Tied the game, his first at bat of the year, as with a home run. So he had two RBIs, two runs scored, a home run, a double, and he reached on an error. So he reached base three out of the four times he was at the plate. So Benny Powell going to be your Autumn Ridge Dental Player of the Game. Now that's something to smile about. Whippets get the win. They move to 1-0. Neshoba Cetnral falls to 0-1 on the season. And hey, we're going to have a return game. Going to be going over to Neshoba on March the 2nd, I believe. That's a Saturday ball game here in a couple of weeks when the Whippets will travel back over to Neshoba to take on the Rockets. So we'll have that game for you here on Breezy 101. Our next scheduled broadcast is going to be on Tuesday. We'll be right back here at the Talon County Fairgrounds, where we will take on Madison Central, the Jaguars, big 7A program powerhouse team coming to Kosciusko to do battle with the Whippets. So we'll have that one for you here on Breezy 101, breezynews.com, and on the Boswell Media YouTube channel. Those streams brought to you by Allen's Furniture. Thank you to all of our partners with us. You'll see them on the screen right there if you're still watching here in the post-game show. And, you know, be sure to frequent those establishments and, you know, tell them that you're a fan of Kosciusko Whippets baseball. Big thank you to Donald back at the studio. He'll be with us all season long, keeping us on the air back there at the headquarters on Golf Course Road. Appreciate him. Also, got to say thank you to Melissa and Lisa, doing some in the sales department, Laura, and also Ashley and BMO, doing some commercials and some graphics. It really is a team effort at Boswell Media Sports when we get these broadcasts on the air. But that wraps up game number one. You can't win them all unless you win the first one, and the Whippets did win the first one 7-1. So we're going to sign off and wish you a good night for our entire crew. It's Breck Riley saying go Whippets.